And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the 2021 Senior Night, honoring this year's Golden Tornado football players and trainers, the cheerleaders and the twisters. The Golden Tornado football team is led by head coach Chris Towery. Our first senior, Emmanuel Brady, a four-year member of the team. He's escorted by parents Emmanuel Kennedy and Celine Brady. Next up, Christian Fontenot, a four-year member of the team. He's escorted by parents Stephen and Darla Fontenot. He's escorted by his mother, Nina Kelly. Parents Joe and Jennifer Ortego. Grace Willis, a three-year member of the training squad. She's escorted by parents Andrew Vinson and Danielle Willis. Next up, we have the Sulphur High School cheerleaders under the direction of Christy Seaford and Skylar Brashear. Ashlyn Goday is co-captain of the squad and a four-year member of the cheerleading team. She's escorted by parents Dusty and Holly Goday. Cortland Grimion, a one-year member of the cheerleading squad. She's escorted by parents Chester Grimion and Jessica Chabre. Lexi LeBeau, co-captain of the squad and a four-year member. She's escorted by parents James and Shonda LeBeau. And finally tonight, we have our senior twisters. The twisters are under the direction of Miss Holly Beth Land. Jessie Harmon is a three-year member of the team. She's escorted by parents Chad Harmon and John and Ginger Simon. Alyssa Hennessy, captain of the team and three-year member. She's being escorted by Jay and Michelle Hennessy. Kelsey Kaiser, co-captain, three-year member. She's being escorted by Jason and Jennifer Kaiser. Cadence Pickle, a four-year member of the team. She's being escorted by parents Terry and Dorlina Pickle. Fans, for all of our seniors, from the football team, the trainers, the cheerleaders, and the twisters, please join us in a round of applause. Council for Golden Tour. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please direct your attention to the 50-yard line? Andy Patton is a veteran of the United States Army, and he graduated from McNeese State University with a Bachelor of Science in History Education in 1989 and a Master's degree in Administration in 1993. His first teaching job was at Vinton Middle School, where he taught history and coached football from 1989 to 1991. He then taught history at Barb High School and sponsored the Leo Club from 1991 to 1994 and made the move to Sulphur High from 1994 to 2002. He moved into administration when he was an assistant principal at Oak Park Middle and S.J. Welch between 2002 and 2004 and became a Sulphur High School assistant principal in 2004, a job he has held until about 2 weeks from now, when he will officially retire. Please help us recognize and thank Andy Patton for his more than 30 years of service to the students of Calcasieu Parish. Captains for the Broncos, number one, Ashton Fusile. And number 59, Kobe Bertrand. Captains for the Tours, number 9, Tag Stelly. Number 52, Emmanuel Brady. And number 63, Kyle Thibodeau. Broncos have won the toss and elected to receive. The Golden Tours will defend the north end zone.
Big game. He's got 28 tackles in his last two games, and last week he had 18 tackles plus a pair of tackles for a loss against New Iberia. So big defensive tackle for the Golden Tours. We'll look to be building on that. We're going to take a quick break for our prayer before the game, our national anthem, and then we'll be back for kickoff between the Sulphur Golden Tours and the Sam Houston Broncos. Stay tuned.
Class President Blair Bowers.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day and for this opportunity to come together in respectful athletic competition. We hope the actions of the players, coaches, and fans honor the gifts we have been given and bring you glory. We ask that you protect these young men during the game and bless all who have traveled this evening. In your name we pray, amen.
Kicking off for the Golden Tours, number 99, Ethan Paez. Kickoff goes into the end zone for a touchback. Broncos will begin 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Hand off to the right side. Gonna get across the 20, about to the 22, and as soon as we say that, we mention big number 47, Mr. Trim. And he's just kind of starting out where he left off last week, Tony.
The little like the linebacker just kind of chopped him low, and Trim cleaned everything up, made sure he didn't progress any.
Yeah, the way they've been playing, you'll hear say Trim and number 5, Hyatt, quite a bit tonight. Stout of being quarterback, he'll put a man in motion. He'll fake a handoff. He's looking deep. He's got a man open about the 40. Catches at the 45, and he's going to go out of bounds near the 50. Let's see where they mark him out. It wasn't really a pick play, just a little switch play right there, and the Golden Tours didn't switch. or one switched and one didn't.
Massey just didn't get over quick enough.
Well, and we ended up with two defensive backs on the one wide receiver, but it's going to be a first down for the Sam Houston Broncos at the 50-yard line, 11:21 to go here in the game. Be a handoff to the right. He's across the 50, across the 45. Literally a shoestring tackle right there. Looks like by number six, Tyler Massey.
He saved that one.
Yeah, it's going to be a gain of 9 on first down. It's going to set up a very short second and 1.
He breaks that tackle. He's still in the end zone.
Second and 1 for the Broncos. Tour, 41-yard line.
Golden Tour's a three-man front, a little different front instead of the normal four-man front.
There's your guy, Trim, again.
Yeah, Trim gets in there and makes a tackle along with number 41 for the Golden Tours.
That's Laidlaw.
Layden Laidlaw. He is going to fall forward, though, for another first down. He just got enough, had to get to the 40, and that's exactly where he got for the Sam Houston second first down of the night, now with 10:43 to go here in a scoreless game in the first quarter. So this looks like Sam Houston's pretty much staying in this base offensive set. They'll have two wideouts and on each side with the one running back. Stout looks deep. A little wheel pattern once again, a little high, but I see number one.
Yeah, if Stelly looks up, that might have been an interception.
Yeah, Grayson Stelly was right there where he needed to be, and if that receiver catches the ball at all, Stelly's going to really tackle through him right there. It would have been tough to hang on to that pass. But that's going to set up a second down now as the pass does fall incomplete. You'll notice as well, Sam Houston doesn't really go into a huddle. They'll line up, like I say, pretty much in this base formation to make an adjustment. A handoff up the middle. He's across the 40. He's not going to get a fumble on the ball. Looks like it's going to be Golden Tour football.
Sulper's got the ball.
I think that's number six, Massey, once again, quickly in the action tonight. Yep. So with 10:19 to go in the first quarter, the Golden Tours with the first turnover of the night. And they'll take over at their own 37-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for the Tours. And out comes Mr. Trahan and his crew.
Well, you know, Coach, we were talking to Coach Fontenot earlier, said that they were playing with quite a few freshmen, sophomore tonight, a lot of injuries, and I don't know.
Well, the thing right there, it looked like he was kind of stopped, and instead of going down, pretty much kept fighting extra yard or so, and then I didn't get the number, but somebody got a hand in there and just kind of punched the ball out.
It looked like on this end, or Stelly on this side, was right on top of
it. So the Golden Tours, they'll set up with three wide receivers on the right. They'll have a tight end power formation there to the left. Stelly starts in the backfield. They'll run a little quarterback keeper Trahan. He's across the 40.
Nice play.
He's up to we call it the 44-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 7 on first down. It's going to set up a short second and 3 for the Golden Tours.
Just stayed right behind Stelly, right on his backside, and followed him up, right up the field.
Yeah, I suspect that's something they've seen on film, Tony, for them to go. They don't run Trahan an awful lot. So I'm thinking that maybe they saw something on film that they feel that they could exploit here as the game goes on.
Maybe a little fake to Stella here. They just brought Blaylock in.
So as you mentioned, 2nd and 3 for the Golden Tours. Trahan will be in shotgun formation. He'll fake a handoff. He bootlegs to his right. Pass is caught right there by number 11 for the Golden Tours, Caden Blaylock.
Really nice tackle as soon as he caught it by number 12.
Number 12 for the Broncos.
He's going to be Leighton Hickman.
He's going to be about a yard short of the first down here, so that's going to set up a 3rd and 1 now for the Golden Tours.
Good coverage. Normally that play develops a little quicker.
Yeah, and Blaylock probably has to, he's got to realize where the sticks are and run just a hair deeper route right there. But nevertheless, it's still a positive play, a gain of 2. Like I say, sets up a short 3rd and 1 from the 46-yard line with 9:04 to go here in the first quarter of a scoreless game.
Imagine you'll see Stelly right at the gut.
Yeah, handoff to Stelly. He's across the left side. He's across the 50, across the 45. He's going to be brought down just didn't quite get to the 45. Gets to the 46 of the Sam Houston Broncos side of the field. And that will be a first down for the Golden Tours, their first one of the night.
You got to give credit to the O-line. That was a hole that I could have ran through.
Yeah, he had a nice hole to run through right there.
Man, I want to give a shout-out to one of our very dear friends, recovering Mr. David Nazat's listening tonight and watching. And Dave, we're all praying for you, hoping you get better quick and come home and see us.
Yeah, from what I understand, they moved David from an ICU room to a regular room earlier this morning, and he had a Stelly's around across the 40s, across the 35. He's going to be near the 30. He's going to step out of bounds at the 33-yard line. That's going to be a gain of about 17 on first down. And it's going to set up another first down. But as we mentioned, David had a test today, and he'll continue to kind of go through that process and procedure. So, but we're glad he's up and feeling a lot better and able to listen to the game tonight. Tune into the Golden Tours.
Yeah, and look, guys, if you guys are out and if the businesses are open, go by Victoria's on Oak and Bob's Exxon.
I believe Victoria's is open out. And Bob's Exxon will be open on Monday.
Perfect. Go by and fill your next tank up over there.
So first down for the Tours now at the 28-yard line. He hands the ball off. Oh, he faked
nice
it, but he hands the ball off to
Stelly.
He's across the 25. He's going to be tackled now at the 22-yard line. That's going to be a gain of 6 on first down.
Stelly just keeps driving his legs.
Yeah, and the offensive line, Tony's doing a nice job of blocking early in this ball game.
They are. They're getting that push. You can see it. You know, they're pushing 1-2 yards off the ball. Pretty easy to run behind that.
Well, and also these positive yards on first down, it really opens a playbook for Coach Towery. And, you know, you can pretty much call anything you want at this point in time. But 2nd and 4 now.
I'd be looking at Blaylock across the middle.
Trahan's going to pitch it to Steady on the right. He's across the 25.
Nice job,
he's going to be tackled. It's another. I think that was number 12 again. Number 47. He's going
to
bring down Stelly at the 20-yard line. We're going to call it
a yard and a half, 2 yards.
Yeah, we're going to call it a short 3rd and 2 now. But if he doesn't make that tackle right there, Stelly's probably down at least to the 10-yard line, if not scores. So it was a nice tackle by number 47 for the Broncos, and that's Mason Falk, a junior defensive back. The Tours will come out with 2 wideouts on the left. They'll have a power formation, double tight ends on the right. Now they're going to move to the left, so they have a – very much a power formation with everyone on the left. Stelly in the backfield behind Trahan. He'll hand off, and they send a blitz.
Nice.
He's
going
to be brought down with about a 2-yard loss back to the 22-yard line.
Yeah, that linebacker just blew that play.
Yeah, Sam Houston sent – looks like both of their linebackers through the middle two holes and was able to get some nice penetration and tackling for a loss. Thought we might see Paez right here. What would be a – 39-yard field goal attempt, but the offense is going to stay on the field now. We'll call it 4th and 4 from the 22-yard line with 6:27 to go here in the first quarter of a scoreless ball game. Sam Houston took the opening kickoff to about the 40-yard line, then fumbled the ball, and the Tours recovered and have been on the mark since then.
Good spot to look for Vizay, too.
Trahan fakes the handoff. He's
nice
up the middle. He's down near
Trahan.
The 15-yard line. It's going to be a first down. Yeah, because, you know, that linebacker, one of the linebackers blitzed again, and actually he tackled –
Stelly.
Yeah, tackle
yeah,
Stelly
right.
In the backfield. And but surprise, Stelly didn't have the ball. And Trahan pulled it and made the right read right there. And it's a big first down for the Golden Tours. Like I said, the 15-yard line, 1st and 10. Well, this running game is really eating up some clock as well, Tony. Like I said, we're down
6 minutes.
For some reason, the clock stopped. I'm not sure what's going on.
First down.
Yeah, but it should start again. Well, now they've finally started. But we're going to be inside 6 minutes to go after this play. Hands off to Stelly. He's inside the
nice move
15, inside
Stelly.
The 10. He breaks it left outside across the 5. Touchdown, Golden Tours.
Went in untouched. What a great move by Stelly.
Yeah, you know, that play, Tony, was designed to go up the middle of the field right there. And Stelly just didn't see an opening. He decided to bounce. He took one bounce outside, and then when he got to about the 10, maybe just inside the 10-yard line at the hash mark, he bounced it one more time. And from there, it was just a foot race to the corner of the pylon. And there's not going to be many guys beat Tack Stelly in a foot race right there in that position. And touchdown, Golden Tours.
Trahan hands the ball off and comes back, and he fakes the pass, which, you know, it froze that safety. It looks like he got it.
Yeah, it freezes the defense just a hair. And the extra point by Paez is good.
And there was no way that safety was going to get over.
So with 5:58 to go here in the first quarter, the Golden Tours with the first score of the night move out ahead of the Sam Houston Broncos 7-0. While we have a quick break right here, let's mention some of our game day sponsors for Tornado Radio Network. Hollywood Barbershop, Troy Darby over in City Service Highway. Troy pretty much assured me he was going to be listening tonight. I went and got my hair cut this afternoon, and Troy, as usual, did a great job with that. And he's definitely looking forward. We got to talk a little bit Golden Tornado football and hopefully also looking forward to Golden Tournaments in the playoffs, so visit about that. Wendy and Mike Koontz with Cajun Monograms right here on Cypress Street. Go see them for any of your monogramming needs and also a T-shirt and other
trophies.
Yeah, they do a lot of stuff. Trophies, monogramming, T-shirts, jackets. David Missey and Missey's Grocery, another former Golden Tour. Go visit David Missey. Probably, I guess he's got the oldest grocery store in town now.
Got to be.
It's going to be another deep kickoff, and it's into the end zone.
But they got one of the best meat departments in town.
Yeah, butcher there. They actually have a butcher there six. I know 6 days a week for sure. I'm not sure about Sunday, but anything you need done, cut. If you're cooking a jambalaya, tell them that you need it fixed up exactly how they fix Don Martin's jambalaya setups, and they'll take care of you over there. Go see David Missey. Sam Houston now will come out first and 10, as we mentioned, from the 20-yard line. 5:58 to go here in this ball game. This time they have three wide receivers to the right. Hand off up the middle of the field.
Nice.
There's nothing
play
there whatsoever, Tony.
Nice play.
The defensive line did a nice job of just holding their position right there. And when that running back, see if I can get a number on their running back.
They just got to pick
number
it
20,
up.
I believe.
Pick it up where they left off last week. That D line dominated last week.
Dennis Gordaire, the junior running back, looks like.
Dylan Abshire has been running the ball a lot, too. I believe number 20 is.
So they'll come out in the same formation again. Three wideouts to the right, one to the left. There was no gain on the play. Second and 10 now for the Broncos. Running back goes out in motion to his right. They were looking like they wanted to fake a handoff. They throw the ball back over the middle of the field. They're going to give him forward progress. It's on number 26 on the reception.
Dylan Abshire. He's not
you just mentioned
him,
yeah. So
hold on for dear life.
He got forward progress up to the 25-yard line. So with 5:03 to go here in the first quarter, the Broncos are going to be faced with a third and five now. Coming off a turnover in their last possession, they definitely don't want to go three and out right here after their defense was on the field for well over 6 minutes in the first quarter already. Once again, running back goes in motion out to the right. Looking back over the middle of the field, against tipped by Hyatt right there.
Almost.
Thought he had an interception. He's going to flag in the offensive backfield. Two things here. Either holding. Yep, we're going to get a holding call against the Broncos. That's going to be declined by Sulfur, and it's going to set up a fourth down and five.
So Don, is that Stout playing quarterback?
Yes. Yeah.
Freshman.
Number 20.
Pass, man.
Yeah, just a freshman.
Throws a good ball.
What's interesting, if I'm not mistaken, I want to say he had a game early this season, maybe in his first start, where he went – I'm pretty sure 300 yards, if not 400 yards. Tony, I'm kind of chuckling.
I see why. He can throw the ball.
I see the back judge here talking to Massey about how he needs a signal for the fair catch.
Oh, yeah.
Remember, we had a little mix-up that last week. So, the snap is there. The kick's going to be up.
I'm sure Snelly
Massey's
going
to have an opportunity
something
to field it at the 40. It's going to be fumbled.
Yep.
It's going to be Sam Houston Bronco at the Sam Houston Bronco football, at the 40-yard line. It looks like it's almost like he came up too far on that ball, and he was trying to catch it overhand, almost right at right in front of his face mask.
He ran up just a little too far.
And so that's the second big turnover tonight. The first one went to the advantage of the Golden Tours, and this one is going to go advantage Sam Houston Broncos.
The Broncos can capitalize on this.
So with 4:29 to go here in the first quarter, the Broncos currently trail 7-0, but are set up first and 10 at the Sulfur 40-yard line. Be a little pitch play to the right. He cuts it up the field.
Not at all. No, sir.
Hyatt makes the tackle, but he's forced up the field to cut it back up to into Hyatt by Peyton LeMaire, number 4.
And number 23. And Elijah Coleman.
So it's going to be a loss of 2 yards on first down.
Who I don't see out there is Cole Navarre.
Number 17, right? I see 17 at the far side.
There he is now.
So Cole Navarre's out there. We'll try to get some of the other players
Stelly
out there as well.
On this side.
So the Broncos are going to stay back in that same formation, Tony. Three wideouts to the top, one to the left. Running back in the backfield.
Yep.
Kind of a legal procedure.
Yep.
That's going to be 5 yards against the Broncos. That's also going to stop the clock now. 3:49 to go in the first quarter. The home team, Sulfur Golden Tours, leads 7-0.
Sulfur's playing Coleman. He's playing safety, it looks like, but he's playing.
He's kind of a rover position.
Like an outside linebacker.
Yeah, he walks up a lot, and I don't know if he's spying on a particular player for them, but, yeah, he kind of walks up in different spots and gives the offense different looks. So it's going to be 2nd and 17 now at the 47-yard line for the Broncos. Empty backfield as the running back goes in motion.
Another flag.
You have another legal procedure call.
Man.
That's going to be another 5 yard. I didn't see anyone move that time.
I didn't either.
Got to be just literally someone flinching.
Is it maybe the center moving the ball, maybe?
Maybe so. Like I say, it's not much because I didn't notice either one of the legal procedure calls. But that's going to set up now a second and 22.
Trim patting the official on the bottom.
And the Golden Tours are going to a dime package right here. Just three down linemen. Obviously knowing this is a passing situation here for the Broncos. Stouts in the shotgun. He drops back. He's looking to his left. Has a receiver there in the flat.
Nice shot.
Looks like he got to about to the 49-yard line. It's going to be tackled by number four, Peyton LeMaire.
Good hit as soon as he turned around.
So that's going to be a gain of about four, maybe five, and that's going to set up now a third and 19 from just across midfield at the 49-yard line.
Go ahead. He had no chance to set up and turn up field.
LeMaire no, like I say, LeMaire was right there on him. And, I mean, Stout didn't really have anywhere to go. They're going to go double tight end right here. A little different formation. Thought they were maybe going to run a screen pass.
That's a pick.
It's going to be picked off by number six, Massey.
Massey.
He's across the 40 to the 45.
He didn't drop that one. He said, I'm taking it.
Now we got a late flag. What's that for? There's no one over here but sulfur players. They're going to call a sideline warning. You gotta be kidding me.
Got to be it, Don. I mean, there's.
Well, is that the very end of the play? There's nothing to be as a sideline warning. What happened was the offense had already come out on the field.
Right.
Right about the time Massey was being tackled. And, you know, as we mentioned, we've been mentioning all season, actually, the sideline warning is a point of interest for these officials. But nevertheless, it's going to be Golden Tour football with their second turnover of the night with 2:42 to go here in the quarter. Golden Tours lead 7-0 are looking to go 54 yards and add to that number right here.
I'm excited to see Trey Hinn get out there and throw the ball around a little bit.
So three wide receivers on the left. Stelly remains in the backfield next to Trey Hinn. They'll run a little quarterback keeper around the right side. He's
across the
45 up near the 50. It's going to be a gain of four. Yeah, like I said, he's doing a nice job of letting his blocking set up and – you know, it's kind of an interesting play because he's really not in a big hurry right there.
No.
And just kind of following all of his players. And
it's a nice gain.
Yeah, it's a gain of 4 yards on first down.
We've got 2:14 left in the first. 7-0 Tours.
So trying to bring him out. Vizier's going to go in motion now. He'll set up on the left. Trahan takes a snap. He'll fake a handoff. He's looking deep to the left side of the field.
Oh, just overthrown.
Just overthrows Blaylock right there inside the 10-yard line. Falls incomplete, and that's going to set up a third and six now for the Golden Tours from their own 49-yard line.
Who was that going to, Don, number 81?
No, it was Blaylock, number 11.
Was it 11?
Yeah.
Well, just over two. I mean, just a half a step.
Yeah, Blaylock has become their deep threat right there, so it felt like it was a good opportunity to take a deep shot right there. Be three wide outs here in a little clump package.
Here's Vijay.
Gets some pressure on Trahan. He rolls to his right.
Oh, nice.
He's got nowhere to throw the ball. He's going to run out of bounds.
Yeah, he had nowhere to set up.
That's going to be a nice stop for the Bronco defense right there, and it's going to set up. That's going to set up a fourth and. From the 46-yard line. I guess he lost a couple yards. That's going to set up a fourth and 10 now. Now we're going to get a timeout. Sam Houston with 1:49 to go in the first quarter.
Well, guys, a beautiful night over here in Mount Walker Memorial Stadium. Tours really looking in control and confident. That punt. Really, the rally cry has been to set the pace for today's game, man. And both Trey Hinn and defense, obviously Trim is out to play again. So it should be a solid night of football here. And looking forward to an easy Tour victory.
Kyle Medea over on the sideline. I don't know about an easy win. You know Kyle, though. He's always feeling good about things.
Oh, yeah.
With Kyle, one thing about Kyle Media, if you show up in a down mood or thinking the glass is half empty, he's going to quickly tell you the glass is not half full, it's full, full.
It's full. It's overflowing. Are you kidding me?
So fourth and 10 now. Pies is back to punt, 1:49 to go here in the ball game. Sam Houston just used their first timeout of the first half. Snap is there. Kick's going to be up.
Oh,
nice kick.
Whoa,
he got a hold of one right there.
Yes, sir.
They're bouncing about the 20 and take a Golden Tour bounce. And it's going to be right near the 5-yard line. It takes now bounces up a couple yards.
Nine. Nice punt.
So that was from the 46. So that's 4 and 42. That's about a 46-yard punt right there. And, boy, Pius, he definitely likes kicking into that south end zone, and there's literally no wind. You know, you would almost think he's got a little wind behind him, but there's no wind at all tonight. The flag is limp as could be.
Well, I was wondering why that receiver was
he was
so
set
close.
Up like it with the 25 or the 30. Yeah, he never had a chance to field that ball at all.
It went 10-15 yards over his head.
Looks like they finally down and got a little confused there with the soccer lines, but looks like they're going to finally down on the 9-yard line. Austin Nelson will love me talking about those soccer lines on the field. That's another story for another time. So a little comeback play the other way.
No, sir.
A little misdirection. He's going to fall forward and be tackled at the 10-yard line. Looked like trim, and I couldn't get enough. Maybe been Hyatt there on the tackle. Nice job by the Golden Tours, because originally that play looks to go to its left, and then he reverses field and takes the snap or takes the handoff and goes the other way.
Laidlaw, Tribb, and Hyatt have been on.
Stout drops back to pass. Looks to his right.
Stelly's
right there,
boy.
Pass was intended for number 13, Quentin Simon. And, I mean, it was like Stelly was like.
Had no chance.
Well, it was interesting because it was almost like Stelly's like, are you really throwing this ball right here? You know, he was all over Simon.
He just swatted it down with his right hand.
That's going to set up a big 3rd and 9 now for the Broncos from the 10-yard line. They really need a first down or two right here. Looks like the Golden Tours are going to call a timeout now with 1:08. As we mentioned, the Golden Tours lead 7-0 over the Sam Houston Broncos. And what's been a pretty action-packed first quarter, Tony.
Yep. It's been a good quarter. You know, barring a couple of turnovers, and I haven't seen many, many penalties, just a few false starts.
Well, Sam Houston had them back-to-back false starts and kind of got them in the hole on their previous offensive possession.
Been pretty clean, though.
Well, you know,
1:08 left in the quarter.
And you want a clean game. You know, obviously, these guys are just across the river over in Moss Bluff, so it's – so I guess you would say it's not as big as the Barb rivalry game, but it's probably next on the list, especially with it being another local team. So most of these kids know each other, and they've played either with each other or against each other a lot of years now. And, the last thing you kind of want to see is, any ill feelings go out onto the field between these two guys. And so there's a lot of respect between the two programs. So expect to see a pretty clean game tonight as well.
Looks like Stelly. Okay, there you go.
So 3rd and 9. Stout drops back to pass. There were 5 wide receivers in that formation. Throws it deep. It's going to be well overthrown. Stelly was on number 13, Simo. And there was a little pressure on Stout. And he throws probably the ball 5-6 yards over the receiver's head. That's going to result in a 4th down. It's a nice 3-and-out there for the Golden Tour defense.
Well, they got a number 81, Ty Stout, playing out there. I wonder if that – are they twins?
Oh, I don't know.
Both freshmen, quarterback and receiver.
Be an interesting pair for the next 4 years.
Yep.
So Massey drops back. He's at about the Sam Houston 42-yard line.
Is that Massey or LeMaire?
Oh, I'm sorry, LeMaire number 4. He's going to fair catch it just inside the 40 at the 39-yard line. And from there, the Golden Tours will start out 1st and 10 now. 57 seconds left to go in the first quarter. They currently lead the Sam Houston Broncos 7-0. You know, one of the things, Tony, we're talking about senior night earlier, the Golden Tours only have about 9 seniors on this team.
Yep.
So, you know, it's been nice to see this team evolve as the season has gone on and grow and progress. And not only that, but, I mean, there's a lot of youngsters on the field. So,
Sulphur is
a lot of these names
same,
will be back next
not
year.
Not the same team we were watching in game.
It's a much different
totally
team.
Totally different team.
Tran Texas, snappy rolls to his right. Pitches at the Stelly at the last minute.
Oh, they're good.
He steps
move,
back.
Stelly.
He's crossed the 40, crossed the 35. Stelly, he's going to be brought down at the 34-yard line. It's going to be a gain of 6 yards once again on first down.
Well, he took the pitch, and he was doomed. And he just planted his right foot and cut back upfield. And
yeah, it was a late pitch.
Found a little lane.
A late pitch by Trahan. And like you say, when Stelly took the ball, he had literally nowhere left to run to his right. And so he planted that right foot and broke it back inside.
So we got Big LaFleur down there with Vize. We saw this a lot last week and against Barr.
Yes, we call it like a true power formation. Now they both shift in motion to the left. They'll fake a handoff to Stelly, and Trahan goes to his right. Yeah. He's across the 25. He's going to be brought down to about the 23-yard line. That's going to be a first down for the Golden Tours.
Man, Don, look, I've only been watching Sulphur since maybe 1990-ish. Trahan's one of the smoothest quarterbacks I've seen all this time.
Well, the thing interesting about that play, too, Tony, everybody on the field, it's set up where that play is going to go to the left, and Trahan goes back to the right. So a tough one to defend. So at the end of the first quarter, the Sulphur Golden Tours lead 7-0 over the visiting Sam Houston Broncos, and we'll switch ends of the fields here. Let's talk a little bit about some more game day sponsors for us. Mike and Jeremy Moore with Taylor Aluminum. For any aluminum needs or patio needs, go see Mike and Jeremy. Jeremy, a former Sulphur Lady Tour. Meade's Garage over on Highway 90. Any kind of
they fix anything and everything.
Yeah,
doesn't matter what model, what year.
Air conditioning, you spark plugs changed, oil changed, tire work done. Anything you can think of to do with a vehicle, they'll take care of you on Highway 90. Also, our three big car dealerships, Mike Willis Ford. Go see Tony Tremonti over at Mike Willis Ford. You also have the Navarre Automotive Group with the Chevrolet dealership on Beglis Parkway, the Dodge dealership on City Service Highway. And then you can't forget about our old buddy, Mr. Charlie Wayne LaBeouf.
Charlie Wayne.
At All-Star GMC over on Highway 90.
About 54, if I don't. Is that right? 54? I think it's 54.
That sounds right. First and 10 for the Tours. They'll hand off to Stella. He goes to the left. He's across the 20. He's going to be dragged down inside the 15-yard line. Looks like they're going to mark him at the 14. He's near a first down. I think he's going to be about a half a yard short, and that's going to set up a 2nd and 1 for the Golden Tours. As we said, first play of the second quarter, the Tours lead 7-0, but are looking to put another one on the board. And, Tony, we failed to mention earlier, but the Golden Tours,
they're in it now,
are in the Chad Norwood Bayou Beds red zone.
Go see old Chad Norwood at Bayou Beds.
Any bed or bed accessory needs, go see Chad Norwood over on Maplewood Drive and tell him Tornado Radio Network sent you. Second down, hands off to Stelly. Boy, a nice spin move in the back phase. Across the 10, across the 5. Touchdown, Golden Tours.
Was not going to be tackled.
He was he was set up to be tackled for about a 3-yard loss.
No, he wasn't. And, he wasn't letting that happen.
I don't know who that number was for Sam Houston, but
he spun right out of the tackle.
He went to grab him and maybe got some fingertips on a jersey, and boom, Stelly was gone. And after that, there was just no one left there.
No one else touched him.
That was unoccupied.
He got in the end zone quick.
Yeah, he got in the end zone very quick. For his second score of the night, Pius is going to be on to attempt the extra point.
Just keep on feeding Stelly. He's a senior. Let him have his
snap is there. It's down. The kick's going to be up, and it's going to be good. So with 11-12 to go here in the second quarter, two plays into the second quarter, the Sulphur Golden Tours capitalized and put the second touchdown on the board for the night and have moved ahead 14-0. Well, we've got a small break. Let's go through some more of our game day sponsors. State Farm agents Jennifer Mabu and Carl Vincent here in Sulphur. We appreciate all their support.
We have one more, Sam Bowers.
Sam Bowers as well.
Don't forget Sam, another big supporter.
And another former Golden Tour and another supporter is Rob Cameron over in Lake Charles.
That's right, Rob.
For any of your AC needs, go see Clayton King and King Mechanical located on Highway 90 in Sulphur. Clayton would definitely take care of you. Clayton took care of one of our other game day sponsors, is Monica and Mike Jackson with Roly Poly Sandwiches. They have a location on Maplewood Drive and also a location on Ryan Street. But I saw on Facebook this week that Mike and them had a freezer malfunction and were probably within an hour or so of losing and several thousand dollars at a minimum of materials. And Clayton King and King Mechanical came into the rescue and got their freezer slash cooler back up and running and saved the Jacksons quite a bit of money over there at Roly Poly's. Kickoff's fielded across the 20, across 25, across the 30. He's going to be tackled about the 32-yard line. Oh. Couldn't tell if it was Deon Paez.
Well, Paez was hit on him.
Yeah. We mentioned Paez, he's not afraid to put his hat in there. He's got several tackles this year on special teams. And this is the second or third week we've seen the kickoff receiving team literally put three blockers on Paez. Imagine putting three blockers on the kicker.
On the kicker,
man. So the Sam Houston Broncos, a nice return right there. They'll be set up first and 10 now at the 32-yard line for their first possession of the second quarter. Stout takes the handoff. He takes a snap. Nice. He hands to number 24. He's got some room out there. He's across the 40, across the 50. Going to be pushed out of bounds. Let's see how far he got. Looks like going to be pushed out of bounds 49. At the 49-yard line.
I think that was LeMaire that caught the angle on him.
The run right there was by number 24, Jackson Landreno. If I got that number right.
It was a good play, just a little shovel pass.
Little right end around. Yeah, a little end around. Kind of caught the tours shorthanded on that far side of the field. His second down, a handoff to the left. He's across.
Nice run.
Had a little seam right there. He breaks a tackle. Nice, you don't see many break a tackle from 47 trim.
Nope.
And he breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage, and he's up to the 44-yard line, so it's going to be a gain of 5 on first down. That's going to set them up second and 5 now.
Yeah, Trim's pretty much a lock. How many did you say he had last week?
Last week he had 18 tackles.
18 tackles.
28 in the last two games.
Wow. You'll get that little end around.
Yeah, that end around.
Didn't quite work out with Mr. Hyatt.
End around this time, and I see Coleman, number 23, and Hyatt, number 5, getting off all that pile. Yeah, there's a little end around play again. He's going to lose half a yard on that play. It's going to set up 3rd and 5 now. Yeah, the Golden, they've run that end around a couple of times now. That's Tony's phone. I couldn't figure out what that was going off. 3rd and 5 now. They fake a handoff. Go to the middle of the field. That's going to be brought in by number 26 for a first down to the 35-yard line. Name we mentioned earlier, Dylan Abshire. So that's going to set the Broncos up with a first down now with 9:47 to go in the second quarter. The Broncos currently trail the Golden Tours 14-0, but Stout's got the Broncos on the move. Go empty backfield. He's looking to the middle of the field. He's going to be initially he's brought down by number 4, Peyton LeMaire. Not sure how he held on to that ball. I think it was cleaned up. I didn't get a number on the – apologize. I didn't get a number on the sack right there. But that's going to be a loss of 7 yards now on first down. That's going to set up a 2nd and 17 now from the Golden Tour 44-yard line with 9:06 to go and the clock moving in the second quarter. Stout. Looks to his right now. He goes back to his left to number 13. He's across the 40, across the 30. Looks like he's going to get right down. He's going to be just inside the 25 to the 24, and that's going to be a first down for the Sam Houston Broncos. So I believe the catch right there was once again number 24, Jackson Landreno. Nice pitch and catch there for the Broncos. And that's going to set him up 1st and 10 now at the 24-yard line. 8:40 to go here in the quarter. Broncos look over the middle of the field. Pass is going to be broken up right there by number Stelly. Number 1, Stelly, but I think we may have a flag on the play. Yeah, I think Stelly may have had a little bit of the jersey right there. And, it's going to be defensive holding, looks like. So they were trying to complete the pass on a little slant pattern to the wideout. So I believe that's a 10-yard penalty. Let's see, from the 24. Looks like it's going to be an 11-yard penalty, Tony. Or no, no, maybe it's half the distance. It's a 15-yard penalty, I guess. So they were on the 24. So that's going to move them down to the 12-yard line. First and 10 from the 12 for the Sam Houston Broncos. Stout takes the hand snap. He goes hand off to the left. He's across the 10, inside the 5. I think he's going to the end zone, but there's a flag on the play. I suspect we're going to get a holding call.
That's going to come back.
Yeah, I think there's a holding call on Sam Houston right there. A legal procedure. They were probably lined up in a wrong formation right there. Probably didn't have enough. Probably not enough guys on the line. He threw the flag right away. So that's going to erase a touchdown for the Broncos. I'm going to move them back 5 yards now from the 12-yard line. So I believe they'll move them back to about the 17.
That's big. That's big.
Yeah, it's real big. That was, like I said, a nice run, a 12-yard run for the touchdown for the Broncos. So that erases the touchdown with 8:24 to go. That's going to set the Broncos up now first and 15, from the 17-yard line. Golden Tours lead 14-0. Stout have a running back in the backfield with him. He'll send a man in motion. He'll hand off to the man in motion.
Pitch.
Across the 20, across the 15,
yeah,
across the 10,
it.
He's going to score.
No flag. Nice play. They've run that 3 or 4 times.
Now, the Golden, no, there's a flag right there on the 11-yard line.
Do we get one holding on?
Yep.
Receiver was holding.
And that's literally the only blocker out there, Tony, was that wide receiver. And maybe that's why there was no one over there to make that tackle.
I have to go back later tonight and watch this and see that hold.
Yeah, folks, that's one of the interesting or good things. Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that, Tony, about putting our games on YouTube. The games are also saved on YouTube. So you can go back at any point in time and watch tonight's game, whether it be later this weekend or early next week on YouTube and see some of the plays. So it's going to set up a first and do my math. First and like 19 maybe? 21,
yeah,
and they need to get to the first and 18, I guess. They need to get to, we'll call it the 3-yard line. Stout takes a snap. He's looking to the middle of the field. He's got a receiver there, and he just overthrows him. It's a very tough catch, though. He's being guarded by a safety, and he's also got a linebacker, Hyatt's dropping back, just dropping straight back into coverage right there. So you really got to get that ball into a small bucket right there.
Yeah, you got to put a little rainbow on it. He kind of zipped it over everyone's head.
So that's going to be incomplete now. Set up a second and 18 now from the 21-yard line. The Broncos currently trail the Golden Tours 14-0, 8:13 to go here in the second quarter. Looks like the Broncos are going to have three wideouts on the wide side of the field, or to the left, one to the right. Running back number 20 will remain in the backfield.
Dennis Gordon.
Stout takes a snap. He rolls to his left. Got a receiver run, a little out pattern right there. It's going to be completed down to about the 14-yard line. That's going to set up a third and 11, as they'll need to reach the 3-yard line for a first down.
Oh, Sober's defense is standing firm. These guys, hold on, just one more play.
That's another big third down for the defense. The defense is, you know, in the past has given up big plays on third downs, but tonight is played very well, especially in third down situations. And we got another one right here, third and 12, we'll call it. Stout drops back. He's
pressure.
Looking to his right.
Incomplete.
It's going to fall incomplete.
Had a little pressure on Coach Tower. He's done a great job here of late with the tours. And
couldn't see who that pass was intended for, but I saw Peyton LeMaire, number 4, was on the coverage.
And,
let's see what the Broncos are going to do.
Looks like number 26.
I think that's the
Dylan Abshire.
No, they're gonna kick it.
Okay. What do we know about their kicking team?
That I don't have any information on that. So
Coach Fontenot wouldn't share all his secrets.
He's gonna mark it at the 21-yard line. So this is gonna set up a 31-yard field goal attempt. I can't see the number on the kicker. Somebody moved. Looked like a right guard maybe for Sam Houston moved early. And that's gonna put it back 5 more yards. So instead of a 31-yard field goal, now it's going to make it a 36-yard field goal. 7:28 to go here in the second quarter. Broncos are trying to get that zero off the scoreboard. Golden Tours currently lead 14-0.
Sober's getting a lot of movement up the middle.
From the 19-yard line.
So now he'll be kicking from the 26, so it'll be a 36-yard field goal attempt. Snap is good. Hold is down. The kick's up. It's a low kick.
Nope.
But it looks like it's going to be good.
Nice job.
So with 7:24 to go here in the second quarter, the Broncos get on the board and currently lead the Sulphur Golden Tour, or excuse me, Sulphur Golden Tours now still lead 14-3. Let's go down to Kyle Medier on the sideline. Maybe we're going to go to Kyle.
Well, guys, Broncos get on the board for the first time tonight, 14-3. Tour's still looking fine. I'm telling you right now, the sideline is very focused. Listening into the offensive game plan, guys, they're going to come out swinging, and defense keep holding. We're going to have a great night, man.
Split the pot ticket.
So one of the things you'll notice as the season has gone on, the Sulphur Golden Tours have just become a whole lot more focused as the season goes on. You know, a lot of times with a younger team, and you know, a turnover or you know, a big possession by the visiting team, you'll see a little swinging emotion. But the Sulphur Golden Tours are very businesslike. They're going to field the kickoff at the 12-yard line. He's up across the 20, across the 25. He breaks a tackle. He's across the 35, across the 40. Across the 50, he's going to be pushed out of bounds at about the 40-yard line. Kickoff return right there was by number four, Peyton Lemaire. That's going to be a nice job right there on that kickoff return. It was what a relatively short kick, so it kind of set up a nice return right there. I believe he fielded it at about the 12-yard line. So that's going to be a 38-10. That's going to be a 48-yard return for Lemaire. That's going to set the Sulphur Golden Tour offense up. First and 10 now at the Sam Houston 40-yard line. With 7:13 to go here in the ball game, looking to answer the field goal for the Broncos, which moved them up to within 14-3 now. Trahan takes a snap. He'll hand off to Stelly up the middle. Yeah. No room whatsoever right there.
They were ready for that play. They stacked up the line. And
yeah, it looks like tackle was made there by number 36 or 38.
36
for the defense, Brian Doge. Second and 11 from the 41-yard line. I think the Broncos, that they stay in this three-man front. I think they're going to have a lot of trouble stopping the run game for the Golden Tours here tonight. We've seen some nice blocking so far by that offensive line.
Really, everybody just crashed down to the right, and he didn't have a lane to open up.
So Trahan has three wideouts to his left, one to his right. He'll fake the handoff. A little inside screen to number 80.
Nice play, and that's gone.
Number 82 is across the 30, across the 20.
Oh,
he's inside the 15. He's going to be brought down at near the,
man,
probably the 13-yard line.
Who is that?
82 is Ashton Alston.
Good job, Alston. Boy, I thought he was in there. He split wide open. Good play.
Yeah, he did a nice job. He had a nice seam right there. When he caught that pass, he caught it in full stride and was able to cut it up the field and just, like I say, head right up between the hash marks. And that's going to set up the Golden Tours now. First and 10 at the 13-yard line, and they're once again in the Chad Norwood Bayou Beds red zone. Their third trip of the night. We got a flag on the play. Didn't see what that flag was for.
It's about the area they give it to Stelly so he could bang his head off of people.
May have been a face mask on the tackles.
Could have been incidental.
So that's going to set them up now, actually first and goal from the 7-yard line. Trahan is in the shotgun once again. Stelly to his right. He'll take the snap. He'll pitch to Stelly. He's got a lot of room.
Oh, yeah.
He's inside the 10. He breaks it back at the 5.
Touchdown,
he's into the end zone.
Stelly.
Touchdown, Golden Tours. So Tag Stelly on senior nights, having a big night so far with his third touchdown of the first half.
I was about to say that, Don, speaking of our supporters, you know that his daddy, Jay Stelly, over at Spot, has got to be very, very proud. Tag tonight, third touchdown.
Yeah, and Tag looks like Tag's got a tag. Tag looks healthy and quick tonight. Golden Tours are lined up for two right here. Though inside handoff, well, there's nothing there whatsoever. Didn't see who got that handoff. He keeps falling forward. I don't know if he doesn't get in,
no,
though.
No, they say he didn't get in.
Trahan and Stelly say he's in, but I don't think he got in. Didn't see who got the handoff right there. It may have been a senior, being at senior night.
Yeah.
So that's going to move the score now to 20-3 for the Golden Tours with 6:09 to go here in the first quarter. Or excuse me, the second quarter, the first half.
One more Prestelli's going to put him in rarefied air. You know, Al Bundy scored four touchdowns against Polk High back in 78. So.
They're still talking about Al Bundy's
record.
That's
right.
Huh?
One more tag and you'll be immortalized like Al Bundy.
Some more of our game day sponsors, Unique Designs, James Moses. Also, George's House of Flowers, George Vanderhey. Go see one of those locations for all your flower and decorating needs.
Go ahead, Kyle.
Paez is getting.
You're wondering about the two-point conversion. That was a special play I heard they put in for Emmanuel Brady tonight for senior night. So I still think he got in, but the refs thought otherwise.
Yeah, so Emmanuel Brady's one of our senior offensive linemen. And actually, me and Kyle got to visit with Emmanuel. Kickoff's going to hit about the three and go into the end zone for a touchback. Me and Kyle got to visit with Emmanuel and his brother leaving the stadium last Friday night. And, man, if you ever want to put a smile on your face, stop and have a conversation with Emmanuel Brady. And we were kind of picking at him about he got hurt late in that ball game. He had to come out of play. And so I was kind of giving him a hard time about coming out and rest, quote unquote, resting the play. And, you know, he quickly told me that the only reason he came off that field is because they made him go off the field, you know. So, he's a senior, been a nice player for the Golden Tour offense, not only on the field, but in the locker room for his 4 years here. And his younger brother is a running back for the Golden Tours, who we'll see, I'm sure, later in this ball game. Stout takes the handoff. He looks to his left.
Oh.
Hyatt and then Mr. Trimmy's there
yes,
to clean
sir.
Things up.
Yes, sir.
So Hyatt's going to initially bring him down around the 10-yard line. He was trying to fight away from Hyatt right there, and 47, Mr. Trim came in to literally clean things up. There wasn't Stout wasn't going anywhere when number 47 got to the party right there. So I see a few defensive substitutions into the game as well. I see number 6 is checked in for the Golden Tours. Stout's got a Tyler Massey's back in the game. Hands off to the right.
Nice.
Excuse me, to his left. He's going to be across the 20 up near the 21-yard line, which is basically just going to get back all that sack yardage. That's going to set up a 3rd and 9 now for the Sam Houston Broncos. With 5:17 in the clock running in the second quarter, they currently trail the Sulphur Golden Tours 20-3 from Matt Walker Stadium on senior night. Game number 10 of the season for both of these squads. Stout once again is in the shotgun. He takes a snap. He looks to his left.
Oh, good job, Bustelli.
Boy, number 13, you know, he's got the envious task of going up against Mr. Stelly, number 1, Grayson Stelly for the Sulphur Golden Tours all night tonight. And Stelly's going to stay in his hip pocket. And once again, he breaks up another pass intended for him. And that's going to be a three and out turnover on downs.
Stelly's like one of those little fruit flies, you know, that just – can't get rid of the dang thing. He's all over him.
The Golden Tours don't have anyone back deep. Looks like they're going to send now number 17 for the Golden Tours. It's going to be a nice kick. It's going to bounce at about the 36-yard line, take a bounce. He'll be picked up at about the 28-yard line. And from there, he's going to be pushed out of bounds. That was Cole Navarre.
Yeah, Cole.
But it was a little bit of a mix-up right there because
Navarre. Nobody was back.
Navarre was looking over for LeMaire. And LeMaire was on the sidelines telling Cole Navarre to go back for the punt. So nice to see that we got out of that without a disastrous play because Cole was trying to just let the ball bounce around. And the more he let it bounce, the more it kept bouncing directly at him. So he finally picked it up. Like I said, the 28-yard line, there was 4 Sam Houston Bronco tacklers there waiting on him. But he's going to be pushed out of bounds. So the Golden Tours will take over with 4:43 to go here in the second quarter. What's been a very productive offensive first half for the Golden Tours tonight. 3 touchdowns for Tag Stelly, and they lead the Broncos 20-3. Trey in a move, Vizzy in motion from the right to the left. Two wideouts on the top, one on the bottom. He'll fake a handoff to Stelly, drops back the pass. Looks like he went to throw the ball. They're going to call it a fumble. I thought it was almost moving forward for an incomplete pass.
It did.
But they're going to call it a fumble. I think Vizier fell on the ball at the 19-yard line. So that's going to be a loss of 9 yards on the play.
We really need to get Vizier involved in the game.
Yeah, we haven't seen Kyle whatsoever tonight. So it looks like that's going to be a loss of 9. It's going to set up a 2nd and 19 now. Clock continues to run. We'll be just inside 4 minutes to go on this snap. Trahan's in the shotgun. All the wideouts to his left. They throw a little inside screen to Hopkins. He's across the 20, across the 25. He's going to be tackled at about the 27-yard line. So that's going to just about get him back to the original line of scrimmage, and he's going to set up a 3rd down and 11 now for the Golden Tour offense.
I don't see Blaylock out there.
Now, I think they've been doing quite, Blaylock's got a heavy, had a heavy workload last couple weeks. Don't know if he's a little nicked up or something, but we saw Blaylock on a catch earlier. No, an attempt. I don't think he had a catch. They tried to hit him deep earlier in the ball game, and haven't seen him back in there whatsoever. I see number 81, maybe giving Dawson Ortego, some playing time. Trahan looks to his right, wide open right there is number 82. He's across the 35, across the 40. It's going to be a first down for the Golden Tours. Number 82, Ashton Alston, with his 2nd catch of the night, if my numbers are correct. But it's going to be another big first down for the Golden Tours. Yeah, Tony, I'm just kind of wondering maybe with a 20-3 lead, they're trying to get
trying to
get some of these seniors a little bit of playing time. One of the nice things about Blaylock is he's just a junior. So we'll talk about players coming back. Mr. Blaylock coming
Alston's
back next year
as well.
So 1st and 10, Trahan takes a snap. He'll hand off to Staley. Fakes the handoff actually to stay up the middle. Tries to hit number 81 right there. We're talking about him. Dawson Ortego falls incomplete.
Pass intended for number 81, Dawson Ortego.
That's going to set up a – stops the clock now with 2:41 to go in the second quarter.
Here comes Blaylock.
That's going to set up a 2nd and 10. Yeah, and as we mentioned, Blaylock hits the field. So, once again, as we mentioned, the Golden Tours at their own 40-yard line. We'll have 2 wideouts to the left. Alston and Blaylock to the left. Fakes a handoff to Staley. Looks back over the middle of the field.
Oh, got
it. Yeah, we got pass
flag.
Interference.
Yep.
Although, you know, that's a questionable call right there because 82 Alston tried to actually kind of go through the defensive back. I think the problem was the defensive back was very – he had no idea where the ball was.
Never turned around.
But Alston did a nice job right there of trying to fight through the defensive back that makes the catch. And if he tries to go around that defensive back, he's not going to get the pass interference call.
Well, here comes John David LaFleur in there.
So now the Golden Tours with 2:36 to go. The penalty is going to move it all the way down to the Sam Houston 45-yard line, 1st and 10.
Big freshman tight.
So you'll see Vizier and also LaFleur in the ball game at tight end. That'd be both tight ends on the left. Now you'll see Vizier in motion to his right. One wide out here on the bottom. Trahan takes a snap, hands off to Stay. I think they wanted to run a reverse play. To reverse play. In fact, he got in Blaylock's hands, and the Broncos did a nice job of Blaylock's cornerback just kind of follows him on that play. And as soon as they hand the ball off, he's tackled for a 5-yard loss. So that's going to bring up a 2nd and 15 now, 2:12, excuse me, to go in the second quarter. Golden Tours currently lead 20-3. They're going to have to call a timeout. Now they broke the – no, they didn't break the huddle with 12. They're just going to substitute in for LaFleur. So they'll get another wideout in the game, Ortego number 82. Or excuse me, Alston number 82. Yeah, now we're going to call a timeout.
Yeah.
Tours just never were comfortable right there with that play they had called.
Going down.
Yeah, the play clock was moving down as well.
It was down to 1.
So let's finish up some of our game day sponsors. Richard Cole over at Fat Boys in Westlake. For any of your home cooking needs, especially at lunchtime, go see Richard Cole at Fat Boys. Kyle Medier on the sidelines with us. Kyle Medier is with J.D. Banks. For any banking needs, go see Kyle Medier with J.D. Bank. Dr. Roger Grimble, Grimble Pediatric Dentistry.
P-Mon.
Over on Cypress Street in Sulphur. For any pediatric dentistry needs, go see P-Mon. Go see Doc Grimble over there. So the Golden Tours, I believe, have their second timeout of the night. 1:52 to go here in the second quarter. Have moved the ball all the way to midfield and moved it to the 45-yard line where they had first and 10. But a 5-yard tackle for a loss by the Bronco defense on first down has moved it back to midfield. So they'll be right at the 50-yard line, second and 15. Trahan brings the offense back out. Trahan will be in the shotgun at quarterback. He'll have three wideouts, two wideouts and Vizier, the tight end, off to his left, and he'll have two wideouts to the top. I see Blaylock at the top, and I think Stelly's at the top as well. So we'll have empty backfield. I think the band, I don't know if that's what they're talking about. The band's almost covering up the play clock. I see there's two referees at the 30-yard line. Not sure what they're discussing. Looks like they're looking for stars. They keep looking, unless there's a light out, they keep looking up top for something.
I think they were discussing whether they were going to have dinner tonight after the game.
I don't know. It looks like we got everything set now.
Here we go.
Yep. So 1:52 to go. Second and 15 now for the Tours. Trahan's got everybody set up. He'll be in the shotgun. Takes a snap, drops back. He's looking to his left. Finds number 11, Blaylock, crossing Bumble. The field. They're going to call him down right there.
Oh.
He's going to be down at the 49-yard line. It's going to be a loss of one.
What a great play. What a great call by the official calling him down.
I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know.
I
can tell you if the roles were reversed, I'd be screaming that was a fumble.
You got that right.
So,
it's close.
But we're going to go ahead and take it. But that's going to set up a third and 16 now for the Golden Tours. Clock continues to run. 1:15 and counting in the second quarter. Stelly's going to be in the backfield along with Trahan. Stelly will go out right in motion. They'll do a swing pass to Stelly. He's across the 45, across the 50, across the 40. He's going to be out near the marker.
I think he's got it.
I apologize. My camera a little slow right there. But he gets that right at the first down marker. He was at the 45 originally, so he needed to get to the 35. That's going to be a first down for the Golden Tours. And there's a flag. Bruce Merchant just gotten here few minutes ago from softball duty, and he notices a flag on the play. Looks like a late hit by the Broncos. Of course, I see number 19 for the Broncos saying it's against Sulphur, so let's see.
Holding call against the Tour.
Well, we had that all finagled up there. So let's sort this one out. So it looks like a holding call to 40. If that's the place, and to move them back to the 50. So that's going to set up a third and 15. They'll replay the down. So that's going to set up a third and 15 for the Golden Tours. Back at midfield where we started a while ago. Oh, now they're going. Now the personal foul, Bruce. You did see that correctly. But now they move from the 50 to the 40.
So they had a hold.
I mean, to the 35, yeah. Hold.
Spot foul. They marked off 10.
And then after the play, a penalty on the Broncos.
Give Sulphur a first down.
And that's going to give the Tours a first down at the 35-yard line. 57 seconds to go here in the half. One timeout. Two wideouts on the left, two on the top. Trahan takes a snap. Stelly was in the backfield. He was looking to his right. Goes deep for the end zone. Got a receiver out there. It's going to fall incomplete. It's a nice job right there.
Hopkins.
By the Sam Houston Bronco defender, really didn't give the wide receiver any room to come down with a catch right there.
Well, that was his catch to make.
Well, another thing.
The defender.
The other thing they teach the wide receivers is to stay about 5 yards inbounds if possible. That way it kind of gives you some room to maneuver there on the outside. But he kind of pinned himself, and also the defensive back pinned him as well. So it was no room to come down. So 51 seconds to go. Golden Tours will be in a tight bunch formation right here. They hand the ball. Fake to Stelly. He'll bootleg to his left.
Oh.
Tries to hit Hopkins on a crossing pattern at about the 15-yard line and just about a foot over his outstretched hands. That's going to fall incomplete and stop the clock now with 46 seconds to go.
Come on, man.
It's a tough pass for a quarterback right there, rolling away from your throwing side.
And you're right, 6 inches, that's.
But once again, sets up a 3rd and 10 now for the Golden Tours. Plenty of time here, 46 seconds to go.
All that talking made Kyle hungry.
Trahan's in the backfield. He'll be flanked by Staley on his left. Takes a snap. Looking back over the middle of the field. It's number 82 right there, Austin. He's going to be tackled inbounds at about the 32-yard line.
Four down territory.
Yeah, they're not. That's not. They're not in field goal range, and they'll probably have to use. Yeah, they'll burn their last timeout with 32 seconds to go. They'll have a 4th and 7 now at the 32-yard line. I believe Sam Houston only has one timeout remaining. But he got a little pressure right there from the defensive lineman and probably had to get rid of the ball a little earlier than he had to, like I say. Positive yards for the Golden Tours. If Austin is able to break a tackle right there, don't think he would have got to a first down, but he would have got 3 or 4 more yards and got him a little closer to the first down. But like I say, this sets up a nice manageable 4th and 7 for the Golden Tours. Little surprised we haven't tried maybe to run a little draw play for Staley on this drive, with the defense thinking that we're looking to pass the ball. Now I think with no timeouts, this may, of course, I don't know if you turn it over on downs, it stops it anyway. But and if you get a first down, it's going to stop while they move the chains. 4th and 7 may be a little bit longer than you feel comfortable running a draw play, but let's see.
Well, you got them in spot for it.
Now you got sulfur. I mean, excuse me. Sam Houston calls a timeout. I heard the Sam Houston coaches holler, but I don't know what they saw. I don't know if they had the wrong defense out there or were having trouble getting lined up against the Tours. But you know, we've seen that several times this year. Coach Tower does a nice job coming out of timeouts of giving the defense a totally different look than what they've seen all night. And I suspect that's what happened right there. And call Sam Houston. I'm not sure if that was their second or last timeout, but call Sam Houston to burn a timeout right there.
He's coaching them up, isn't he? Look at him.
Yeah, Coach Tower has done a real good job. And, you know, it's been another thing. As the year's gone on, you know, we saw some plays, and, you know, I guess off the air, we talked about it a little bit, Tony. We saw some plays that I just didn't agree with some of the offensive play calling. You know, that we saw, and it was plays that just weren't working.
They weren't, but and they're as working the season,
now. No, but I mean, some of them, we kind of got rid of them.
Some of these plays are working now, I think, no, because they've kind of come together.
But what I'm getting at, I guess, is Towers made an adjustment, and as the season's gone on, and the stuff that wasn't working, you know, we got rid of it. Trahan looks back deep. He's got the scramble here. He's across the 35 now, across the 30. Yeah, he broke the line. He knew he was across the line. He wanted to throw the ball, but he knew he was across the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
And that's going to be a turnover on downs. He's going to be running out of bounds at about the 36-yard line. So the Broncos will be set up now with at most one timeout remaining. But they'll be set up 1st and 10 now at their own 31-yard line with 23 seconds left to go. Like I say, yeah, Trahan looked to scramble. I think when he first broke, he thought he could get the first down running the ball. And then he looked up, and Sam Houston did a nice job of converging on him.
And he tried to pump fake him.
Yeah, at that point.
He didn't fall for it.
Yeah, at that point in time, he was past the line of scrimmage. So as we mentioned, they're going to be set up now 1st and 10. They'll come out in their offense. They'll be probably looking to see if they can break maybe a quick play right here. Be a wide receiver screens across the 35. Grayson Staley's out there.
He's an animal for a little guy.
And once again, the pass was completed to number 13 instead. It's like, I let you catch one in this situation, but, yeah, you're not going anywhere.
Picked up 3 yards.
And Sam Houston, now they're going to use their last timeout of the night. They're going to be set up 2nd and 4 now at the 37-yard line, 16 seconds to go. So, Tony, probably I suspect maybe what you do here is you either, two things. You either look to the middle of the field trying to get a first down where you can run up and clock it and get one more maybe one more long pass into the end zone for like a Hail Mary play. Mm-hmm. Or you'll throw a little out pattern and look for the receiver to get out of bounds and stop the clock.
And then
get a, you know, maybe 2nd and 4, so you can pick up a short first down and still have, you know, 11 or 12 seconds to go. But let's see what they do here.
I imagine Trim and those boys are going to be you know, rushing, trying to get in there.
Not Trim. Trim's not even in the game right now.
No, he is.
Oh, he's at nose tackle.
Yeah. Oh.
Pass is going to fall incomplete. Yeah, he ran a little out pattern right there. Lucky it wasn't intercepted off the tip. But if he caught that ball, he would have been out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. So, yeah, they're just looking to move the ball a little bit upfield right here.
Who is that DB right there? 18 on Sulphur. What is that, 18?
18 for the Golden Tours.
Carson
Covan. I think he's a linebacker.
A linebacker. Boy, if he looks up, that ball almost just bounced off his face mask.
So 12 seconds to go. Golden Tours lead 20-3. Sam Houston throws a little pass out to the right to number 13. He's going to break a tackle across the 40, across the 50.
Oh.
He's going to be tackled. Boy, that may have been a saving tackle right there by number 23. That's Coleman, I think, Elijah Coleman. Is going to make the tackle at the Golden Tour 43-yard line. Only 4 seconds to go. They'll clock the ball now. I see they got zeros on the clock. Let's see if they – I thought he might have got that playoff.
They might give him one.
Yeah, I'm thinking they got 1 second. Nope, they're going to call a halftime. That's a little surprising right there. I thought he was able to clock it in time.
I agree.
So, at the end of the first half, the Golden Tours are quite an impressive offensive showing here in the first half. Lead the Sam Houston Broncos 20-3.
It's been real fun, man. I'm going to bow out and let old Bruce take over.
So we're going to go. I thought we had a halftime visitor, but I guess we don't.
No, I don't see him up here. So
we're going to
take a little break.
Yeah, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to turn the camera on to the Golden Tour marching band. I think the Golden Tour Marching Festival is tomorrow.
Actually.
Right here. And right here at Matt Walker Stadium. I'm not sure the start time. I don't have any of the details. But anyway, so the band's getting ready for that performance tomorrow. But like I said, we'll leave the cameras on the band. We're gonna take a – looks like about a 20-minute break, kind of catch our breaths. And Don Martin and Bruce Mergent will be back for the – and Kyle Medier, excuse me. We'll be back for the second half of Sulphur Golden Tour football on Tornado Radio Network and CPSBTV.org.
The Broncos, under the leadership of Captain Andy Bonin, co-captains Casey Orsak and Camille Guidry, and Lieutenant Emily Guillory.
Good evening, Sulphur High School's Hornet Golden Tornadoes. Principal Shannon Folks, Mary Scott Conrad, Brian Chamsey, and Jason Jagno, and band directors Terry Gould and Taylor Teague proudly present for your halftime entertainment the 2001 Sam Houston Pride and Spirit Band. The band is under the field direction of drum major Sidney Pulowski and assistant drum major Hope Smith. Band captain is Ethan Andrews, first lieutenants Dallin Bro and Jacob Brewster, second lieutenants Elizabeth Moon, Emily Curall. Drum captain is Harrison Self, color guard commanding officer is Natalie Richard. Drum major, is your band ready for performance? The band will perform their 2021 contest show entitled Chaos. The Pride and Spirit will be in competition tomorrow here at Sulphur High School. Marching contest, showtime for Sam Houston is 3:45. Pride and Spirit, the field is yours. Thank you.
Now entering the field, we have the 2021-2022 Sulphur High School Twisters. The Twisters are led by Captain Alyssa Hennessy and co-captain Kelsey Kaiser. They are under the direction of Mrs. Holly Beth Land. For halftime, the Twisters will be dancing to What's a Man Gotta Do, played by the Golden Tornado Marching Band. Please welcome to the field the Sulphur High School Golden Tornado Marching Band. The band captain is Sydney Hill. Band lieutenant is Andrew Castro. Guard captains are Cortland Grimion and Rachel Vincent. Drum captain is Khalil Owens. And front ensemble captain is Abby LaBrie. Brass captains are John Leger and Wesley Littleton. And woodwind captains are Brianna Simon and Kaylee Stevens. Guard lieutenants are Brooklyn Billings, Alice Hebert, and Riley Stoops. Drum lieutenants are Caleb McLeod and James Odom. The band is under the direction of Matthew McMillan. Tonight the band will be performing their 2021 show Redux, featuring music from the Stravinsky Ballet, The Firebird. Drum majors Ezra Chavez, Sophie Medwick, and Peyton Turner, you may take the field. Thank you. Thanks to the sponsors for the Golden Tornado Marching Band, Kona Ice, David and Amanda Trahan, Paul Perry Orthodontics, Jennifer Maboo State Farm, Cajun Monograms, 4D Outfitters, Kim Cool, and Lyondell Vassell. Our thanks to all these sponsors of the Golden Tornado Marching Band.
Martin and Bruce Merchant coming back to the second half from Matt Walker Stadium. Tonight's matchup between the Sulphur Golden Tours and the visiting Sam Houston Broncos. And Tony Tremonti helped us out in the first half. And Bruce is here after. Bruce, how'd the softball game go between them with the McNeese Cowboys? Was it just their little fall World Series game or something?
No, actually, it's an exhibition game with the newest school in the state, Louisiana Christian University. And they played 10 innings, and McNeese won like 21-2, something like that.
Where is that university at? That's a new one on me.
That is
I follow a lot of sports.
Formerly known 2 days ago as Louisiana College.
Louisiana. I saw that now. Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So you got me with the play on words there.
Yeah, Louisiana Christian University now.
Bruce, before we get started here, let's talk about I'm going to let you brag a little bit on yourself, or I'm going to do it too, but I mean from what I'm being told, you're being given an award tomorrow at McNeese.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about that.
It's the Lewis Bonnet Award, named after the guy who actually gave me the job out at McNeese. It's the Southland Conference Media Award that they hand out every year. Usually they do it at their football preseason stuff in July. And this is the 11th version of it. It was my honor to get it tomorrow.
What a nice thing. That's a very congratulations on that, Bruce.
Thank you, sir.
I've only been working with you off and on for 2 years now, and I've really enjoyed working with you. I've learned a lot from you as well. And so it's a very well-deserved award.
This is Tag Stelly. Oh, they're going to bring it back. He gets it all the way into Broncos territory, but it's going to come back at the midfield.
I think we had a push up. I think that was LaFleur. You're not going to miss the 6'7 kid usually when he pushes somebody down.
No.
It was bad as that was really behind the play.
Yes, it was. Holding will be the call, actually, so they'll move it to the 40-yard line. Still great field position for the Golden Tours. I have missed not seeing Sulphur the last 2.5 weeks.
Bruce, you missed a great game over at Barr.
Oh, I know.
I don't know if you had a chance to go back on YouTube and watch any of it, but, man, it was a – you know, it was kind of one of them typical throw the records out the window. Mm-hmm. You know, Sulphur, while Sulphur controlled a lot of the game, turnovers kept Barb in the game. But, yeah, missed a – and then obviously last week a hard-fought – 4 quarters of hard-fought ball against visiting New Iberia.
I was actually watching Barb last week at Acadiana. That was not pretty. Trahan will take the snap.
See Brady in the game. His first action of the
is that him?
Yeah. You know, Brady, to fill you in a little bit, Brady had a fumble last week and had a fumble at Barb as well.
Okay.
And so I would venture to say Mr. Brady has been working quite a bit on ball handling.
Hanging on to the football.
The last several weeks. And, of course, I mean, Tag Stelly's a senior. And
well, that and you're going into the playoffs, you got to have more than just Tag back there.
Yes.
Because, yes, the Tours are heading into the playoffs. It's just a matter of where.
A little fake pitch play. Trahan rolls to his right. Going to have LaFleur open at the 50s across the 45 and brought down to the 42-yard line. I think the ball may – they're going to call him down.
Yeah, he's down.
So we're going to go to going to go to Kyle Medier on the sideline. I think he talked to Coach Towery coming out of halftime.
Good for a first down. Broncos 43-yard line.
Trahan's going to throw to the far side. It is complete. Down upstairs. There he is.
Yeah. Tell him Raymond said he needs to call a better game tonight.
Pass complete to Johnson Hopkins, Jr.
And
What's up, guys? Down here talking to my buddy Raymond Don. He said you need to call a little bit better game tonight. But back to better news. Coming in after halftime, I got to talk to Gage. He said he's going to do a little better job working on his route reads. And talking to Trimmy on the defensive side, he said a little bit better job filling those gaps. But other than that, just a lot of minor adjustments. And they're looking forward to staying in control of this game.
Second down, they'll hand it to Stelly with the first down and more as he comes to the near side, the 30. 25, and he's pushed out of bounds. I was looking at the stats in the paper earlier this week for Gage Trahan, and he's not a flashy quarterback. He doesn't throw for 400 yards a game. The guy's only had three interceptions all year long. And for any quarterback, nine games into the season, that's really something that caught my attention. Does a great job of protecting the football.
You know, I think the other thing, Bruce, with Trahan, each game, what we've noticed is he controls the game now. He mm-hmm. really feels comfortable with his offense. And he knows, see right there, just that little fake pass. I mean, nothing was open. He pulls it down. He's going to score. He's inside the 10, touchdown Golden Tours.
Yeah, I agree. He each week he has gotten better and better, and so has this whole team. And it's now 26-3.
You know, the word I was looking for, comfortable. He's just
– That's good.
Every week he gets a lot more comfortable with his offense. Not only the offense, the plays, but the offense itself, the line and everything else. And, you know, he's clearly become the leader of this Golden Tour offense.
He is the holder here for Paez. Another guy who's had an outstanding season for the Tours. This kick is good. It's 27-3. Sulphur on top with 10:28 to go in the third quarter. And, you know, you hate to go back and continue to lean on what has happened here in the last 18 months or so. But, you know, especially in defensive coach Towery, 2020 was just, you know, hey, you just got to play some games. That was it. But 2021, you got to do what a normal high school football team does week in and week out. And you started to see that with this team about the time they started district. Once you got past Acadiana, each week it got better and it got better. And they've won, what, four of their last five?
Well, and on top of that, I mean, let's even go back a year further. You know, Sulphur had a coaching change after, what, game three.
Right.
So finished out the year with, you know, interim head coach in John Paul Duhon. Well, he did a great job, you know. And so you go through that season and even into some of your off-season conditioning without a true program per se, because the head coach isn't there yet to put his program in.
Paez's kick is short to the 13-yard line, to the 25, and that is about it for
Quentin Seymour on the return.
Seymour.
Bruce, I don't know if you noticed, we talked about it earlier in the game. Trim had, well, you weren't here, but Trim had 18 tackles last week.
Wow.
He's got 28 tackles his last two games. And we literally would almost joke last week about
9 yards on the return.
I guess Trim's going to make one more tackle, and bam, he'd make another tackle. And so he just had one of those career games last week.
Well, that's the same thing on the defensive side of the football. You get comfortable. You're used to the schemes, and just starts to appear a lot better.
You know, the
swing pass is complete for about five.
This game tonight, you know, I guess with the with them running that straight spread offense, Sulphur's gone to a three-man front to give him another mm-hmm. defensive back, linebacker in the game. And, you know, the three-man front really surprised me. They slid Trim to nose tackle. And he's done a nice job there. You know, isn't a normal position for him, I guess, throughout the year. And defensive line has played real well tonight, just playing a three-man front.
On the pistol formation. And off to Dennis Gardier. He'll pick up nothing. Third down and five coming up from the 30-yard line. Gavin Stout, the quarterback, a freshman quarterback. They've had a lot of injuries early in the year, the Broncos.
Yeah, we mentioned, I think, Andrew Glass, who's we called his name quite a bit on the baseball field. But
yeah, there he is.
Andrew Glass, I think, may have got hurt the first or second game into the season. And for the most part, they've had to play Stout, a freshman, for the majority of their season. Oh, boy.
This one is incomplete. Threw it little bit quicker than he wanted to.
I think 18 is Kovan. Somehow it just went right through Kovan's hands. I thought he might have an interception out there in the flat. But that's going to bring up a fourth down for the Golden Tour defense.
And Sam Houston, like Barb, is a team that didn't play last year.
You know, it's been interesting. We had that discussion earlier this season, which I never thought about it, actually, until I think you brought it up. But we had the discussion about some of these teams throughout the area that did not play last year really look.
Yeah, they struggled. I know early they did.
Rough on the edges and struggled this year. So
one comes to the near side. The mayor will get out of the way, takes a bit of a Sam roll. About the 32-yard line, that's where Sulphur will play a first and 10. They're going to back it up. We're going to have a
flag on the far side.
Yeah, I think we're going to have a personal foul on Sulphur over on the far side.
Golden Tours will take over there first and
involved
10.
Grayson Stelly, the Sulphur side.
Grayson Stelly, I'm going to say this in a nice way. Grayson Stelly has played mad tonight. He had a couple of very physical tackles in the first half, and he's pretty much been locked up with number 13, Quentin Seamon. I'm assuming is our number one wide receiver, and he's been man up on Mr. Seamon the majority of the night, and he's won that battle so far.
Well, that's 15 against Sulphur for the personal foul at the end of the play. And with 8:59 to go to the third quarter.
Golden Tour is currently nursing a 27-3 lead over the Broncos.
They're moving all the way back to the 17-yard line.
Yeah, I thought I'd moved our camera far enough.
It was at the 40-yard line. It ended up being stepped off from the 33.
Almost like it was a spot foul or something.
Oh, it was, yeah. Or maybe from where the punt was.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, where
the punt was never fielded, though.
Right, right.
So maybe where it stopped.
With
the
bounce, it bounced all, all the way down to the 33. So actually the 32, so then moved down to the 17-yard line, Bruce. First and 10.
Brady in the backfield. Trahan. He will hand it to Brady on the left side. He has wrapped up pretty quick.
Brady on the carry.
And brought down by O.J. Patterson, one of the senior linemen for Sam.
So this is pretty interesting, Bruce. You know, we've talked about all season that Stelly and Brady are two different type of runners. Stelly hits a hole very fast, and Brady's a little bit more methodical. And so Stelly had a lot of, you know, a lot of times you see one have success and the other one struggles a little bit. Brady's had struggled on a couple of his carries. Stelly had a lot of success in the first half, really hitting the holes hard and quick. So we'll see how that carries over into the second half of Brady.
Nice snap. Brady has it again, and he's going to be brought down for a loss again. It's Patterson who has him wrapped up. Actually, he never goes down. He has stopped. Marked it at the 17, so it's still a loss of a yard. Bring up third down and 10 for Sulphur from their own 17-yard line as they are up by 24 here.
Yeah, you know, one of the visit with, this has been years ago, but talking to former coach Paul Bourgeois, when I said that high snap, other than a penalty, coach said that was the biggest drive or play killer on the offense. He said a high snap just disrupts all of the timing, and that's what you saw right there.
So third and 10. Stelly to throw, or rather Trahan to throw, and he throws it through Vizay's hands.
And they haven't been able to get Vizay on track tonight. I think that's his first pass even thrown his way. And Trahan had to get a little mustard on that thing. It was going between two defenders. And Vizzy, I think, just never really had a chance at that ball.
So Paez will enter the game as the punter. One man deep for Sam Houston. It's Quentin Seamon or Simon.
He set up, looked like it right at the 50-yard line.
You know, Paez had a win at his face.
Paez had a 46-yard kick in the first half, Bruce. Punt.
Nice one here. It will take a nice Sulphur bounce.
Well, that is a nice
inside
bounce.
The 35. That's where they'll grab it.
Especially considering he was punting into the wind.
48 yards on the punt by Ethan Paez.
So three and out for the Tours. 7:21 left here in the third quarter with the Tours on top, 27-3. Final home game, at least in the regular season, for the Golden Tours. They'll be on the road next week.
donated an extra.
Not sure which way we're headed yet, no. But we're pretty much definitely guaranteed a road game.
Yeah,
we won't move up enough spots to get in the top 16.
Most close teams to us are over in the Baton Rouge area, Woodlawn, Saint Amand, I think Ouachita.
Yeah, I saw 2 weeks ago. I saw before the New Iberia game. I saw us matching balls on the ground.
Yeah, and that Sulker's got it. Yeah. Well, yeah, that's true.
He's right, yeah,
yeah, it would be an incomplete pass. That is correct.
It was a little shovel pass.
Yeah, he tried to pitch it forward, and that is a pass. So
2 weeks ago, early on, had us going to Saint Amand, and then I saw last week we actually dropped a spot after kind of a weird thing, but it's the power rating system. But we dropped a spot after the win over New Iberia due to New Iberia not having any wins in the season. And what you thought you saw was after last week would have been headed to. Baton Rouge.
Yeah, Woodlawn.
Woodlawn.
Yep.
Second and 10 now.
Oh, look at the blitz.
Ooh.
And a hard sack.
Let's see who that is. Number 50, I believe. Huh?
Yeah,
that's a Colin Kelly.
Yeah.
So, Kelly,
the 10-yard loss. Stout is brought down at the 25-yard line.
Well, not only that, even though it's a Sam Houston quarterback there, Bruce, I mean, that was a tough.
Yeah, he fell on him.
Yeah, I mean, there was nothing malicious or intentional about it, but, I mean, yeah, he just flat fell on him. That's a play there. You all sometimes see a shoulder separate just the way he fell on him.
Collarbone injury, something like that. Stout to throw again. Goes far side. That is caught. Well, that's a great play. And he's going to get away and could score. Yep, he will score. That is going to be a 75-yard pass and catch.
Well, I almost think the ball may have bounced through a defensive back for the Golden Tours.
Yeah, I thought he'd at least knock it away.
And then it's almost like it went through his hands, and then they both kind of fought for the ball. And the one that was fighting with the receiver, he fell off, and the other safety wasn't able to bring him down the tackle. And after that, it was just a foot race to the end zone.
Is it 26, Dylan Abshire?
Probably so. Abshire is kind of one of their go-to guys.
Yeah, he's the holder here for the extra point.
Kick is up, and it's going to be good. So with 5:53 to go here in the second, the second half or the third quarter. The Broncos answered the Tours touchdown on their opening drive, and the score is now 27-10.
Our apologies to the split spot winner. We got her name wrong.
That was interesting play. Tours had a chance to bring him down right at the first down marker.
Yeah, they had a chance for an interception. Then they had a chance to break it up. Then they had a chance to bring him down. And just kind of a weird sequence of events for the defense.
None of those
right there.
Things happened.
But, you know, Bruce, even though you're working on a 27-10 lead right here, I think it's very important that the offense comes back out and kind of establishes momentum back to the sulfur side. You know, you got a little momentum with that big play on the Sam Houston sideline. It may not surprise me to potentially see an onside kick right here. Only going to speculate. But he lines it up on this right hash mark. He's lined it up there all night long. But, you know, obviously it's – giving your return team a thought of, hey, he may try to onside kick in a particular play right here. So we'll see what happens. Just something to think about.
The kicker is Dallas Connor, and he's going to kick it deep. Well, attempt to kick it deep. It takes a nice bounce. The Tours have it at the 25 and the 30, about the 32-yard line.
Our return game tonight has looked much better.
It's LeMayer.
Don't know if it's that's directly related to our return game or that's directly related to the defense of the Sam Houston kick coverage team, but return game has definitely been much improved tonight, so that's nice to see for the Golden Tours.
A decent field position to start the drive. The Tours up by 17 here. That's the midway point of the third quarter on a very cool night here at Mount Walker.
Yeah, that cooler weather cooler weather rolled in.
Yes, it did yesterday. And the handoff to Stelly.
Back in the game.
Yep, trying to bounce it outside. He'll pick up 3 to the 35-yard line.
You know, Bruce, one of the things we mentioned earlier, and I'll go ahead and mention it again.
Stelly on the carry.
But, Stelly's kind of holding
on. Yeah, no, I didn't like the way he went down.
Yeah, he's kind of funny. He's fought a little shoulder arm issue off and on throughout the season, and he may have just felt a little awkward right there. But, And we mentioned earlier that one of our good friends and Golden Tour sponsors, Bob's Exxon and the Nizet family, but David's recovering from a heart transplant.
Yeah, I saw that.
In Houston right now, and not sure if he's still tuned in or it's past his bedtime over there. They're taking great care of him. But I want to encourage all of our listeners. You know, they as a family, they made a decision to shut the gas station down so they could be with David.
Elijah Brady on the carry.
Obviously, that's a family-owned business, so you know they take a direct hit there from a business standpoint. But we're encouraging all of our listeners to go by the you know, Sulphur's only and last full-service gas station. But go by next week, and I'll be up front, full service. You're gonna pay a little bit more at the gas pump, but go by and fill up a tank of gas at Bob's Exxon this week, and tell those guys thank you for supporting supporting Sulphur all these years.
After the first down run, there goes Brady again. And again, some room up the middle. He's going to get five more.
On the stop, number one,
and I was also corrected by one of the ladies this week. They said, you know, our Vicky owns Victoria's on Oak.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, you don't have to get a tank of gas. You know, go maybe go get your wife or your girlfriend or your mom something nice over at Victoria's on Oak. So go see one of those, their family businesses. And like I say, show them a little support while they're going.
It's Christmas time.
Going through it. It's quickly Christmas time, Bruce, once again.
Heard them on the radio, songs today.
Nice hole right there for Brady. Oh, yeah. Up the millions across the 40. Score. Across the 35.
Caught from behind nice at the 5-yard line.
That's a nice hustle play. I didn't get a number.
22, Dylan Bell.
Yeah, let's give
free
a
safety.
Let's give a kudos to Dylan Bell. It would have been easy on that play. You know, you're down 27-10, Bruce, and Brady breaks free for a long touchdown run. It would have been real easy for them to kind of just put it in cruise control and let Brady score. But he tracks him down to 5-yard line where the Golden Tours will have first and goal, and they're in the Bayou Beds red zone looking for their fifth score of the night.
And it will go to Brady, and he is immediately swallowed up. Let's see, the first guy to hit him was the last guy to get up.
Brady on
68. That's Leroy Doucette.
You know, Bruce, I mentioned after the game last week, I got to visit with Brady and his brother, Emmanuel, another offensive lineman. And, you know, you talk about two wonderful guys to visit with, and had a nice chat with Emmanuel leaving the stadium, and, you know, was really excited about the season and looking forward to senior night here tonight.
Second and goal to go from the 8. And Trahan will fake it, throw it into the end zone. Yep, wide. He had his choice of wide open receivers. That was Hopkins Jr.
He's going to reward number 10, Jonathan Hopkins, with a touchdown.
He faked that. The play fake to Brady, who carried the ball in all but one play, I believe, of this drive.
I didn't get the other wide receiver out there, but yeah, he had two of them he could have thrown to right there.
And just like you said, they come back and they answer the quick score by Sam. And take care of any momentum the Broncos may have picked up.
Well, like I said, the other thing that does is, you know, like I say, Sam gets a little bit momentum right there and are feeling good about themselves. And, you know, Sulphur walks out there and just marches on down the field and puts up more points on the board. And so that just completely swings momentum back in to the Sulphur Golden Tours here on senior night at Matt Walker Stadium.
68-yard drive didn't take very long. Brady had the vast majority of the yardage down. Two big runs for
And I think probably Elijah. The biggest thing you would hear out of Coach Tower, not only Coach Tower, but probably Mr. Brady himself as well, is that ball security on that drive. Like I say, he's had a couple fumbles last two games. And so I know it's something that and you know, as well as that, Sam Houston sees that on film. So I guess the first thing that the Sam Houston defenders do every time Brady puts the ball in his hands is they're looking to rip it out.
2:47 to go in the third quarter. The Tours up 34-10. Paez will put this one into the end zone. It'll be 20-yard line starting the drive for Sam Houston.
I tell you what, Mr. Paez has liked this cool weather because I think that's his either third or fourth kickoff into the end zone tonight.
Well, and you start this in August when it's 95 degrees. When it's 59 degrees, you feel a whole lot better. As a jogger, I understand that too. You run a little bit faster.
Well, the first one he put in the end zone to open the game, I looked up thinking he had a north wind behind him, and the flag was just laying still. So, like I said, that thing's going tonight.
Stout throws deep, incomplete. Yeah, that's going to be pass interference on Sulphur.
Yeah, that's
I was about to say that was close to interference. And
it's Coleman out there with him and just got a little too physical right there with him.
Yeah. He'd overthrown him.
Pass interference to call against the Golden Tours.
So that'll be 15 yards and a first down for Sam Houston at their own 35-yard line.
Yeah, that's one of the ones that hurts right there, too. Like you said, I don't think he would have was going to be a completion.
No, I don't think so either.
Whatsoever.
That'll be a first down.
They got just enough of him
at their own 35-yard line
to get the call. The first down Broncos via the penalty. Stout will throw to the far side, and that was a weird-looking play. The Golden Tours almost could have picked that off for six.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest with you. I thought that was a lateral right there.
It was very, very close. Carson Coban, number 18 for Silver, broke that up.
And your problem is that your side judge on this side he was still set up at the line of scrimmage, so it's really tough for them to see that quick hit and play right there. It's second and 10.
Two receivers to the left, one down here at the right. And they will hand it off to the man in motion. He's going to throw it. Not a very good throw, and it is incomplete. Threw that very short.
Yeah, I think that was after 26.
Yes, it was.
He's kind of their gadget guy.
He was trying to get it downfield to half of his number, Quentin Simon. And he was guarded very well by Grayson Stelly.
Yeah, we talked about that earlier in the first half, you know. Simon runs out here, and like I said, I'm going to suspect he's their main wideout. And he's been locked up with Grayson Stelly most of the night. And Grayson's done a nice job of pretty much just taking that target away.
So third and 10 from the 35. Here comes the pressure. The throw is complete at the 40 to the 45. Cutting back near side 50, 40, 30, 20, and out of bounds. I thought maybe there'd be a horse collar on that, but nope. All the way down to the 15-yard line.
50 yards on the play and a first down for the Broncos.
60-yard pitch and catch for the Broncos.
Yeah, when he first grabbed him, that's the first thing I thought about was he's going to probably stop the touchdown, but that's about to be a penalty. And I think he kind of slid off just enough kind of to the side of him on the tackle where he was able to escape the penalty. But nevertheless, big first down.
They will run it to the near side, picking up about four on the play for the Broncos.
It's
Dennis Gardere.
Brought down by number 47, Keegan Trim.
Well, it looks like we're going to have a track meet here in the second half, but that's okay. The Tours are up by
second and six from the
four scores, so they can trade him the rest of the night.
Yeah, the problem is, Bruce, you got a big lead right here. You don't want your defense to get sloppy.
No, going to fall into bad habits. Stout throws to the end zone and is caught for the score.
Yeah, he ran a nice pattern right there.
It's Simon.
Navarre was on the coverage, and like I say, he just kind of, Navarre kind of bit hard on him when he broke it back to the outside. Navarre was behind him a step and couldn't close the gap right there.
80-yard drive.
And as you mentioned, the track meet, because that only took him a couple minutes to go 80 yards.
It's 1:39 to go. Connor's kick is good. It's 34-17 now. We have 1:39 to go in the third quarter.
And the Broncos 17.
Bruce, let's mention some of our Tornado Radio Network game day sponsors. Hollywood Barbershop. Troy Darby over at Hollywood Barbershop on City Service Highway. Go see Troy. And he also has a couple young ladies cutting there as well. So not only men's haircuts, but ladies' haircuts as well. Made a little visit to Troy this afternoon to get cleaned up somewhat. Wendy and Mike Kuntz, Troy's a former Golden Tour, and so is Mike Kuntz. But Wendy and Mike Kuntz over at Cajun Monograms on Cypress Street. Go see them for T-shirt, jackets, monogramming, trophy, T-shirts. They do a lot of things over there. So go see Miss Wendy over there. Another former Golden Tour, David Missy, Missy's Grocery, over on the north side of town. Go visit David and Missy's Grocery for all your grocery and meat needs. Kickoff bounces at the 30. It's going to be recovered by the Golden Tours.
That Stelly just fell on it wisely. Don't need to attempt to pick that up.
You know, Grayson had a couple kickoffs to him last week as well.
Another flying somewhere?
Well, there was a little pushing and shoving after the play. I couldn't tell where it initiated from. But Sulfur was trying to get Stelly off the field, and that may be where it came from.
Yep.
But, you know, it's one of the things that Sulfur's got to be careful of right here. You know, Sam Houston may get a little, you know, got another score. So they've got leads down now to 17, 34-17. So you're going to have to watch things. And, like I say, Sam Houston may get a little chippy on that side of the ball, trying to come up with some turnovers or some big plays.
You try to bait Sulfur into the penalties, and you don't want to do that. Because you are in control.
So that's a big penalty. That moves them from starting out near the 30-yard line, now moves them just inside the 15 to the 14-yard line, where they'll start their third possession of the third quarter. As we mentioned, Sulfur Tours lead 34-17 with 1:38 to go here in the quarter. Trahan remains at quarterback, and we haven't seen Stelly back on the field after what appeared maybe to be a shoulder arm injury. So Brady's in the game at tailback. He'll hand off to Brady up the middle.
Elijah Brady on the carry.
It's going to be a nice gain of three on first down. Tours have done a very good job tonight on first down of getting positive yards, anywhere from 4 to 6 yards. And we talked about it earlier. It really opens up the playbook for Coach Towery when you get positive yards on that first down.
I think early in the year that was a problem.
They stayed behind the chains, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. You can't have first and, or second and nine and second and eight.
And then, yeah, just our offense kind of just isn't designed to overcome those big yards play. Sam Houston sends an all-out blitz right there, and Brady's going to be dropped.
He ran right into it. Grant Matthews specifically.
And this is one of the things I mentioned. You know, Sam Houston's kind of got to do some different things here to try to get back in this ball game, especially that penalty. Like I say, pins us deep in our territory. Mm-hmm. Really takes away some of the probably the play calling as far as passing the ball. So the Tours were looking to maybe get a first down rushing the ball, but that's going to be a loss of two, and it's going to set up a third and nine now from the 15-yard line. Trahan takes a snap, looks out to his left. He's got a receiver out there across the 20, across the 25, and that's going to be a big first down for Ashton Alston, number 82. But like I say, probably even bigger. That's going to move the chains and give this Sulfur Tour offense, and that's going to bring us also –
well, he was out of bounds, I think. So I was about to say, if it was first down, it would be the end of the quarter.
They'll wind the clock now. Let's see if Sulfur tries to get one more playoff before the end of the quarter.
Oh, no, you can't do that.
Here, we're down inside. Yeah, they can let it go now.
Let's see. Acadiana was up over Lafayette. I think that was 34 to 7.
So let's see if we can get some other score. Bruce, if you'll work on that, I'm going to mention some of our other game day sponsors. Mike and Jeremy Moore over at Taylor Aluminum. Go see them for your aluminum siding or patio needs. Jeremy's a former Lady Golden Tour. Meade's Garage over on Highway 90. Go see Meade's Garage. They can take care of just about, I think about all they don't do is collision work, but anything else they'll take care of over there for you with your car.
Ryan Smith is the 14-year-old son of Ryan and Stephanie
Smith. Arb is up 24-12. They've got Como this evening over in Lake Charles.
Also want to mention great support of our auto dealerships here in town. Mike Willis Ford over on Beglis Parkway. For any of your new vehicle needs, go see Tony Tremonti over at Mike Willis Ford. Also, the Navarre Auto Group, the Chevrolet dealership located on Beglis Parkway, and also the Dodge dealership located over on City Service Highway. Go see any of those guys as well. And we can't forget about another former Golden Tour, Charlie Wayne the Bluff and Cade Guillory over at All-Star GMC on Highway 90.
Jennings winning a shootout with Westlake right now, 42-35.
And I think Westlake went to that game probably only with maybe two losses at the most. That would be an upset right there.
I couple of district losses, a loss on the play here.
Stelly on the carry.
Or Brady. Or no, Stelly.
Stelly's back in the game.
Yeah.
You can see him.
Yeah, he's limping now.
Coming up a little gimpy.
Yeah, I think he needs to.
That wasn't the arm now. I think now it's
yeah, that was a leg. He'll come trot off the field
just
here.
Saw number 22, Garrison Burgess. He's listed as a defensive back. If I got my numbers right. Number 22.
Southside will blast New Iberia. They'll finish 0-10.
Ooh. Yeah, number 40 right there. Boy, he
Reese Young had a touchdown in his hands.
Well, he knows it. He's not going to get an opportunity much better than that. Trahan had a couple receivers out there and just tried to force a ball. I was thinking maybe we'd see a screen pass or something. You know, Sam Houston's really sending, especially on first down, they're really sending blitzing seven at a time. Or not blitzing seven, but sending seven between the defensive line and the blitzers. And kind of put Sulphur back behind a change now, 3rd and 13, and Coach Tower is going to call his first timeout of the second half.
1:14 to go in the ball game. The Tours are up 34-17.
Yeah, I'm not sure if see the referees, man. I don't quite understand what the big I know that referee doing all the waving down there. And yeah. He'll quickly throw a yellow flag, I promise you. I don't understand.
I'm not sure what he's doing. They're making him get on the other side of the numbers,
I guess.
The
numbers, yeah.
Okay.
But, like I said, that's been a big point of contention. But what's interesting is you look over, you know, you look over on the other sideline, and they're out further than Sulphur. And you don't see any of that activity, you know, by those side judges. But, I mean – anyway, I guess that's
six officials tonight. At six last night, St. Louis finished up their season here at Matt Walker.
Yeah, I thought it looked a little short tonight.
I don't know who the white hat is. We had Brian Myers last night.
That's going to bring up 3rd and 13 now on the 23-yard line. Tours need to reach the 36.
Brady in the backfield with Trahan, who will throw. Looks near side, throws that way, complete. 35-40, 45-50. Ball is loose, and they're going to say down again. That's Alston.
Yeah, that's one of the – Sulphur's going to definitely work on that. That's their third play that I've seen tonight that they've called him down. And I'll be honest with you, I think one of them was a fumble. And the two were down, though. I think he was down right there as well. But, you know, you get on the road, Bruce, and those plays there, especially in the playoffs, a lot of times those plays aren't going to go in your favor. So they'll need to get that cleaned up this week in practice.
Nope, especially since you'll be the road team. Here's Trahan keeping inside the 50 to the 45 to the 40, still on his feet at the 35. And a flag will go down. He never does get out of bounds. But they're not even watching him anymore. They say he stepped out of bounds anyway at the 34. But a flag down 10 yards further down the field.
But, you know, Bruce, that's what we just talked about. He faked the handoff right there, and they actually tackled the running back for about a three-yard loss, one of them linebackers that blitzed. And nice job by Coach Tower right there changing up his play calling. See what the flag's going to be for. See a lot of pointing.
Yeah. You're going to wave it off.
Going to wave the flag off. That's interesting.
It'll be first down Sulphur at the Sam Houston 34-yard line.
Yeah, I'm almost wondering if they're saying that flag was thrown after he stepped out of bounds.
I think so. And it must, depending on what the penalty is, it wouldn't matter anymore.
I would.
I don't know. There we go. What was that?
Elijah Brady on the carry.
Sorry about that, folks. I'm not sure what that was.
Yeah.
Gain of 5 yards.
Sounded like RF, but I don't think that's an issue because we've never had it before. Anyway, Sulphur picks up 5 on the first down. That's what it sounds like is getting interference from somebody. I don't know where it's coming from.
I think it's coming from the sideline, Mike.
Oh, okay. Highly likely, yeah.
I went ahead and just killed it for a minute.
Yep. Highly likely. That's where it's coming from. Elijah, no gain on the play for Brady to bring up third down now. The Tours will need to. Now, Brady's coming off the field, and Stelly will have to come back on.
He's holding that same
line. Yeah.
Third
and seven
for the Tours from the 31-yard line.
Surely we got more than two running backs. He'll lose a yard. It's going to be third down and seven.
Well, yeah, no. What's bad, you know, is Cerise is, from what I understand, I believe Cerise is going to be out for the season now.
Yeah, I think so.
With an injury. So he was kind of your third string back or third string tailback.
So third down, they're going to throw deep. Nice throw. And was that a nice catch? No, it was out of bounds. He caught it. Blaylock caught it, but he lands out of bounds.
That was in that corner right there where I couldn't see.
Yeah, I can't see it very well either. That's a heck of a catch. But he was out of bounds when he hit the turf. The Sulphur coaches are trying to convince them otherwise, but
we're at a field goal range right here, so it's going to be fourth and sixth.
9:04 to go.
Golden Tours lead 34-17 over the Broncos.
Stelly remains in the backfield along with Trahan. And they will throw over the middle. Tipped it incomplete. Went off the hands of Austin.
Well, that would have been a tough catch, but I think a ball Austin will probably tell you he needs to come down with right there. Trahan did a nice job of getting that right in that little pocket, but just wasn't able to come up with the ball for the first down.
I wonder if his hands are as cold as mine. That may have been part of the issue. So 8:59 left to play. 34-17 Sulphur.
Updating District 3-5A action at halftime. It's Barb 24, Como 6.
Barb and Como going nowhere. It's 24-12.
Now, what I found interesting, Bruce, is Sam Houston runs a lot of plays out of the same formations. They only have about three or four different formations.
Out of the pistol, they will throw it. Stout goes deep, far side, and there's a whole bunch of bodies flying everywhere. But there is a flag, an eligible man downfield.
Yeah, that's a nice job by this back judge, I thought, because the receiver and the defensive back, the ball was well overthrown, and feet kind of got tangled up right there, and I was waiting to see if he reached in his pocket for a flag, but I think he realized what happened as well. So there's no flag that way. But as you mentioned, had a lineman downfield. Yep. So I think Sulphur's going to move him back. I think it's just a five-yard penalty, but they'll repeat first down.
They'll back him up. You talked about the lack of formations and things. I guess that's part of the deal when you have a bunch of freshmen. Especially a freshman quarterback, you just really can't complicate it. You have to make it as easy as you can.
Yeah, they like to run three wideouts to the wide side of the field and one wideout to the short side of the field.
They run a screen here, and it's very successful. Abshire will get it out across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Yeah, what was interesting about that play, he had a lineman next to him when he caught that ball. I think, fortunately, it was a short enough pass it was only about a three-yard completion, and he ran for the remainder of the yards. But he liked to have a lineman downfield once again.
Same formation. Now they want to try the same play. This time the Torres covered it up and he'll throw it away.
That may be a
He got it beyond the line of scrimmage.
He was out of the pocket, I think, though. Yeah. He got it passed along because there was no receiver over in that area.
No, he threw it well over everybody.
Yep.
So to bring up third down and five for Sam Houston from their own 36, trailing it by 17 here with 8:20 to go. Start in the pistol formation. Now they'll shift out of it. Blitz is coming. The pass is incomplete. Thrown over the head of Abshire.
I think that was Massey out there, number four. Lamaire. Yeah, Lamaire, number four in coverage.
Depending on the play, number four.
So fourth down coming up. I guess if you're Sam, go for it.
Fourth down for the Broncos.
Yeah, I mean, you're down 34-17, 8 minutes to go.
You got two wins.
Yeah, and you're not going into the playoffs and trying to somehow figure out a way to upset the Golden Tours right here. So you got to go for it.
And they get it. First down, Sam, as they get him to jump.
You know, that's a That's a play that's given kind of haunted Saul for different times throughout the season. And I don't know if
they call it first down.
It's close.
I thought the same thing, too, when they started
like
walking it off.
Looked like he needed about 5 1/4. Yeah, when he started walking off, exactly.
It's the bad news for Sulphur is that the clock wasn't running, so. Now we got a false start. You're going to get the 5 yards back. It'll be first and 15.
Dead ball false start against the Broncos.
Sometimes it's nice sitting next to the opposing coaches. You get to hear all kinds of neat things. Sometimes not so neat.
So a lot of times stuff we can't repeat on the on the air.
I think it was Barb 3 or 4 years ago sitting over here on radio and what it got bad. All right, first and 15 now, the ball back at the 36. Stout will roll to his right, the throw. And it's incomplete. Not sure exactly who he was trying to get it to. Abshire there. It's over his head, and there's a flag down.
Stout's pass goes
picked it up.
Incomplete.
Let's see
on the
if
Bryce Fontenot.
There is a call.
You know, Bruce, a friend of mine, is filming on the sideline for KPLC.
Actually caught that touchdown play, or near touchdown play. Okay.
And he said after the replay, he actually came down on his knee in bounds.
Oh, okay.
And but we'll take it is what it is. It's a very tough call to make down there.
So first down, Sam Houston at the Sulphur 49. Roughing the passer call on the far sideline. Blitz comes. Stout throws incomplete. Throws it just out of the reach of Jackson Landrino. Off his hands.
Hey, guys, right now, definitely got the game in hand. Would like to see a few less penalties, especially the personal foul calls against the Tours right now. Coach is just telling them to kind of settle down. Let's play through and finish strong.
Yeah, don't do anything goofy. Just
appreciate that. Kyle Mady down the sideline, getting a little different perspective.
Another false start.
Yeah, we talked about a few of these false start calls. Sam Houston literally has to just be barely flinching.
Yes, I don't see him either.
Well, I saw Lamar pointed at the slot receiver, but I mean, I never saw. You know, it wasn't noticeable enough.
According to the last one and the coaches next door, everybody moved. Here comes a blitz. Stouts escapes the first one, and he's going to get hit from behind. And you can see that one coming. Yep, ball is going to be picked up by the defense, breaking away and heading back down toward the field at the end zone inside the 15-yard line is Dylan Bird.
Did you get who was on the
No, I did not.
He missed him initially.
Yeah, you could see him coming from behind.
And then he kind of gave him that tomahawk chop.
Yep.
And much as I hate to say that, it's almost that chop that our Astros felt from the Braves earlier this week.
We don't need to discuss that. I got a message from a friend last night. Have you recovered yet? No. Leave me alone.
Yeah, give me a week or two.
Yeah, leave me alone. The worst is yet to come.
So that's going to be Golden Tour football with 7:49 to go, currently leading 34-17.
Pistol formation, Stelly in the backfield. Behind Trahan, he will get the football left side. It's a nice little hole, gets it close to the 10-yard line.
Stelly sitting on 3 touchdowns tonight on senior night, looking at the fourth one.
Yes, I heard the reference to Married with Children earlier.
Al Bundy.
Al Bundy. He was my hero. Second and 6 coming up. Y'all missed the halftime conversation. It was old TV shows. All in the Family to Seinfeld. To
Sanford and Son.
Yeah, Sanford and
Archie
Son.
Bunker.
Yeah. A second down and 6 from the 11. Stelly again, he sees that big hole, he cuts into it, and he'll score.
You know, he had a touchdown run like that earlier before you got here in the first half, Bruce, and you know, the play is designed to go all the way, like a stretch play out there. You know, he just sees congestion out there and really just plants that thing. And a lot of times I think there's not a gap there yet. And he's just kind of running up in there waiting on that gap to open up, and it just kind of opens up for him and scores for the Golden Tours.
Well, this one did to his left. Cuts into it and scores. Paez with another extra point. He's only missed one all year.
It's going to be a penalty on Sanders.
We're getting roughing the kicker. Dead ball foul on sportsmanlike conduct.
Sulfur?
Really?
That's kind of surprising because I saw the sulfur player laying on the – looked like a Sam Houston guy was actually kind of walking over him. He's laying on his back.
Huh. Oh, well. You're up 41-17 with 6:58 to go. You don't want to see that, but at the same time, it's not hurting you. So don't get too comfortable with the tee there, Ethan, because you're not going to be kicking from the 40.
So that would be a 15-yard penalty. That's going to move them all the way back to the,
yeah,
what, the 25?
Yeah, back to the 25, yeah. Well, now they're going to move it up.
Yeah, he must have went the
wrong
way.
Yeah, he's going the wrong way.
Like I said, we mentioned it was the sulfur player was literally laying on his back, and it was a Sam Houston guy walking over him, and another Sam Houston player was trying to get the one Sam Houston player headed to the sideline. So,
getting a little chippy here tonight.
So, as we mentioned, 41-17 coming off Golden Tour. Tack Stelly's fourth touchdown of the night, coming off a big turnover, a sack and a fumble return back inside the 20-yard line, leads to another Golden Tornado touchdown.
That'd be squibbing this. And they are. And it is picked up by Sam Houston inside the 30-yard line.
Kickoff covered for the Broncos.
That's
87, Ivar Moniki.
Yeah, 87, Ivar. Monic.
They'll take over first and 10.
Well, there's no sense in kicking it into the end zone. Well, it's first and 10. Sam Houston from their own 29-yard line. Tours back up now by 24.
You know, there's another player I haven't seen tonight, and I'm assuming is injured. It was a big playmaker for him 2 years ago. We'll get to it after this play.
Oh. Scott is hammered as he throws
Man,
football.
Boy, he was hit right there. Luke Uhas.
Uhas, yeah.
Uhas played last year, I think, at Notre Dame. When Sam Houston canceled his season, he moved to Notre Dame. But as a sophomore, he was a wide receiver and a quarterback. And I haven't seen him at all on the field, so I'm assuming that's a
I think he's been hurt.
And that's
also
a huge injury for Sam Houston. As I mean, he's an all-state caliber. He was committed to Texas A&M for baseball. And not sure if he's still going that direction or not, but that's a big loss. It's a nice play call right there by Sam.
And it is well blocked. There's nobody out there. And this is going to be caught at the 15-yard line. It's not Abshire. There he is. It's 20. The 20 or 80? 20.
Number 20. That's their tailback.
Guard air, yeah.
Yeah. And I think the tackle was made by number 17 for the Golden Tours. You see, he's Cole Navarre, and I see him.
Yeah.
Or just go down and take a knee and get an injury timeout. I think he's still up. Maybe go down to a knee and get an injury timeout right there. Nice hustle, though, by Cole Navarre.
The clock's running. You don't want to stop the clock.
Yeah, we talked about the Sam Houston defensive player earlier tracking down Brady from behind to stop a touchdown, and Navarre does the same thing there for the Golden Tours.
Jump ball in the end zone is incomplete.
You see, that's an interesting play call right there, Bruce. If, you know, I see Navarre, you know, kind of hunched over, really in trouble. You got the wide side of the field where he's at.
I was thinking the same thing.
And I go right at him the next play.
I was thinking the
exact same
thing.
He's still looking to the sideline, almost like.
Come get me.
Yeah. But you go right at Grayson Stelly, you know, our top what we consider our top defensive back for an incomplete pass. Anyway, I just thought, you know. especially like I said, this, I love working to this wide side of the field right here. Because, I mean, look right there, Navarre's on the aisle. There's no one else out
here. And now there's nobody on that side. They go in motion. This is Gardere running it on the right side. He'll pick up seven.
Nice hard run there by the running back.
And bring up third down and three. The good news is it keeps the clock running.
Yeah, the clock continues to wind now. Going to be in just inside 6 minutes to go now. Golden Tours lead 41-17 over their, I guess, cross river, cross parish rivalry with the San Houston Broncos.
It's a different river. Houston River as opposed to the Calcasieu.
Bruce, you weren't with us, but it sure was nice to bring that trophy back home to Sulphur after that ball game.
This one is caught. Looks like it'll be a first down.
Simon finally got one on Stella. That's only about his second catch tonight.
I think they mark him about half a yard short.
He stepped out of bounds. He was spinning trying to get the first down. I think he stepped out of bounds. That's going to set up a fourth and one. Let's see if the Golden Tour defense can stiffen up here.
They went out of bounds, so the clock has stopped.
Sam Houston may have to, no, there's plenty of time. Yeah, so they may have to burn a timeout and run a player on the field late to give him 11.
This is a wildcat for the touchdown. Ashton Fugelaire.
So Ashton Fugelaire is a young man. I'm very familiar with him. My son coached him in baseball, and he's a really plays anywhere on the baseball field, and I believe is maybe going to LSUE, maybe. Play baseball, I don't remember, but a great all-around athlete. And, didn't realize that was him in that formation right there, but
I didn't either till he ran. I could see the number. This is interesting.
Never seen him
honor the kicker. Yeah,
and he goes from being a right-footed kicker to a left-footed kicker.
This is Chase Smith.
Yeah, number four. He's a senior. That's it.
And his kick was ugly, but it's good. Yeah, good for him.
Yeah, good.
Because Connor's a senior also. So
it's good recognition there by the Broncos, and got the senior kicker on the field. And what probably is going to be his last field goal / extra point attempt of his career is good for the Broncos. And they've tightened it back up to 41-24 now, 5:32 to go here in the fourth quarter. Bruce, I think Coach Towery's probably over there kind of patting his offensive lineman on the shoulders and pretty much saying, okay, guys, we're going to kind of put this in y'all's hands and just kind of work this clock down to hopefully the three zeros.
Well, I'm just thinking the last two or three weeks how much better this team is than even what we saw against Pineville, which we began the season with a win.
We talked about that, actually. Interesting enough, Sam Houston started out the season 2-1, and Sulphur started out the season 1-2. And Sam Houston coming into this game had lost five consecutive games. Like I said, there's a lot of issues, a lot of injury issues for the Broncos, and because there's a lot of talent on that other sideline, so I'm not taking anything away from them. But, you know, it's been nice to see, like you said, the tours, things kind of come together as the season goes on.
From the 30, it's Lemaire to the 39-yard line.
Well, Lemaire was a tackle away from making things a little interesting on that return right there.
Graham Matthew keeps him from continuing at least beyond the 50.
But, you know, one of the things that the coaches look for and look to stress as the season goes on is they want to see improvement from each game. And if you're around whether it's football, basketball, baseball, if you're around the athletics enough, you know, you can see which teams get better every week and which teams digress every week. And, you know, Coach Towery puts a lot of emphasis, I think, I guess because they never were in a huddle. They had 12 guys on the field and they run one off. I was waiting for us to have to burn a timeout right there. Stelly's in the
Stelly, Stelly's still running across midfield. The 45-yard line, Sam Houston territory.
But I can tell you one of the things that Coach Towery talks about is the process. And not only has he done a great job this season with the process, he's done a great job of having the players buy into the process. And, you know, he often emphasizes taking care of the little things. You know, take care of the little things, and don't worry about the score. Don't worry about, quote-unquote, winning the game. Let's take care of the little things, and we're going to win the little things, and that's going to lead to the big wins. And I think that's what you're seeing with this team this year.
They're up 41-24, under 5 minutes to go. They'll run it with Stelly again. Get a couple of yards, maybe three.
Tag Stelly on the carry.
That's Fuchelaire, helps him up. Bring up second down and eight. And one of those losses was a forfeit, so Selford didn't get to play a second game of the year. So, you know, usually you make your best progression from the first to second game, and Selford didn't get that opportunity against Notre Dame. But lost to Southside, and they've won every one since. This has been a down year for this district. Usually 3-5A is much, much better than what we've seen.
And a legal procedure call.
Yeah, it looks that way. Or maybe delay a game.
We see 22 in the game. I think that may be who moved right there. Like I said, my roster has 22 listed as
Garrison
Burgess, a junior defensive back. And the Tours may – haven't seen much of Blaylock in the second half, so I don't know if maybe he's a little nicked up.
That's
right, him in
the slot.
So maybe just trying to get some reps for some other players, but I think that may have been one of the wideouts that jumped.
They will run it with Stelly.
That's a nice cutback.
Lots of blocking in front of him. He will get it down inside the 20-yard line. Well, apparently he's okay.
You know, I asked Coach, I'm not going to get into the injury of the situation, but I asked Coach that. I said, man, sometimes Tag just gets up and it looks like he's done.
Yeah.
And he said, Tag is one of those young men that somehow he just has a way of, you know, he goes, I look at the sideline, I think he's out. He's out of the game. And he said, you're right. He drags his body off the field, and he said it's almost like he sits there a minute and maybe somebody rubs some magic mojo on him and all of a sudden he's back in the game, you know. And he said, I never worry about if Stelly's going to get back in the game for us.
Well, I guess he knew the play was never in the huddle. He's going to get the football and he's going to pick up good yards again inside the 8 to about the 7-yard line.
You know, sometimes it probably also helps when your dad's a physical therapist as well. So
well, it could be, yeah.
When you go home, you literally can get 24-7 service.
Don't cost nothing. He's going to come off now.
We appreciate Jay Stelly and Spot Physical Therapy just across the way, taking care of all of our athletes, as well as Rand Prince over at Southwest as well. They take great care of all of our athletes, young men and young ladies.
Is Trent Menard in the backfield, 25?
Yep, he's just a sophomore.
Yeah, there he goes to the 5-yard line. And I thought for a second he had a touchdown.
So, yeah, that's a new number.
25, Trenton Menard's a sophomore running back.
It's Ricky Menard's son. Somewhat a long story there, but I still call him family. A family member of mine actually didn't realize that his son was – well, the other day I really felt old, Bruce, when I saw Ricky after the game and didn't realize that Trenton was a sophomore already. And so Trenton's grandma and aunt are probably tuned in all the way from Disney World in Florida right now. So I hope they're still listening to the game. I know I sent them the link earlier so they could listen and possibly watch tonight. So hopefully.
He's got the football, but he's going nowhere this time.
Yeah, that play, like I say, Sam Houston really sent everyone.
He ran right into Tyler Hebert.
Sent all their linebackers right there. He's tackled for about a 1-yard loss, I think. But like, as we mentioned, the big thing is clock continues to run now.
Right.
1:30 to go here in the ball game. The Golden Tours lead 41-24. We're going to have, looks like, second and goal now from the 7-yard line, I believe.
Yep. You're going to head into the playoffs with a 6-4 record. That's good. You'll be over 500.
And you're heading to the game playoffs with a multi-game win streak. So you're playing good ball right now. You know, the other big thing is, Bruce, they're just sending everybody. Menard's going to be tackled again for about a 1-yard loss. But, you know, the other big thing is the way the bracket sets up for us right now, unless there's an upset, you know, if Sulphur's able to come out their first road game, you see number 27. We're going to give some numbers out. 27 checks into the game
now.
That's
Cerise.
And tailback Jackson Cerise.
We haven't seen him in a long time.
I think we're going to be in victory formation.
Okay, that's why he's out there.
Yeah, so what a nice senior. Nice gesture. Like I said, we mentioned Jackson Cerie, I believe, is out for the season now. And
no, they have to run a play on third down, so that'll do it.
So that's one of the best formations. But Bruce, what I was mentioning was if Sulphur goes on the road, and so they'll go on the road. I guess you'd say as an underdog per se, but they'll go on the road, and if they're able to get a first round victory and the favorite wins across from them, they'll get a home game, which is really, if you're going into the playoffs as anywhere from 17 through 32, in my opinion, that's a perfect, that's a nice setup because you get that second round game at home.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, get someone to travel here. And if you get past the first two games, a lot of times it's kind of up for grabs in. You know, you gotta get a little momentum in the playoffs. But, you know, from that standpoint, you know, kind of looking back on tonight, you know, big game from Tag Staley, four touchdowns. And Sulphur really, you know, Trahan didn't have the big offensive passing game that we've seen out of him the last couple weeks. And Sulphur leaned a lot on their run game tonight and just kind of grounded out a big 41-24 victory over the Broncos.
And hopefully you move up a couple of notches because, you know, obviously you want to play someone that's not in the top 10.
Yeah, Iowa got us a win last night. You know, you want all your opponents. I'm not sure. Pineville was playing Ouachita tonight.
I think Pineville, I don't know if they're at home or not. Yeah.
Which is going to be a tough game for them.
Yeah.
And then, you know, hopefully we'll get another victory out of Notre Dame tonight. So we'll get a few.
Yeah, Notre Dame was up by double digits.
Yes,
easily.
A few PowerPoint assists there. So
because in the district you're going to get some and you're going to lose some at the same time. So those are the three that you really need to look for. And you know, you get lucky, maybe number 21 or 22 or 20 all lose. And you might jump up to 21 or 20, and then you're not playing up.
And just
eight or
a,
nine.
Yeah, just from a player standpoint, like I said, the only noticeable thing I saw was Brady left the game, I guess, early fourth quarter with what appeared to be a shoulder injury. So I guess it'd be interesting to see how that works out for him this week. And hopefully we can get him back on the field because, as we mentioned, you'll need more than one running back. In the playoffs, especially the type of running back that Tag Staley is. You know, he's just such a hard-nosed player that he'll get a little nicked up and a little banged up from time to time. But so right now the plans are we will be on the road next week. I think, Bruce, I heard you say you were going to be in Texas for McNeese Thursday night game.
Yep.
And
but
then
wherever.
You'll meet us on the road on Friday night. So I believe the show with the – They'll know something tomorrow.
Yeah,
I don't know
noon.
If it'll be announced, but the parent show usually comes on at noon or 11 a.m. on Sunday.
Yeah, sometime or late on Sunday morning.
Well, you know, it used to be on CST. I don't know.
Yeah, CST, I think, doesn't exist anymore.
No, it doesn't exist anymore. So just kind of
out.
Stay tuned. But, I mean, obviously, once we have some details, we'll post information on Tornado Radio Network to give you an idea of where the tours are headed. And you can make your plans. And as I mentioned, we're talking with Howie Seymour this week. Head by Bob's, Bob's gas station on Highway 90 as you head out of town next week and get you a tank of gas and help support the NESAC crew. And, Dave, we're glad you were able to tune in tonight. So, we'll be on the road next week, and we'll better bring Dave another ball game. And hopefully he's as happy next Friday as he was this Friday. But so on behalf of Don Martin, Bruce Merchant, Kyle Medier, we're going to sign off tonight, and we'll see you next Friday. Stay tuned. We'll be back with Golden Tour football. Hey, Bruce, one more week.
Yes, sir. Bring it on. They win tonight 41-24.
See you guys.